Now they might know, so...
Maybe.
Also, they got season 2 was right during the writer's strike.
It was. It was right during it.
That was bad.
It was really, really bad. Hi, everyone. We're talking about Heroes on NBC.
Uh-huh. And not the Heroes...
Probably not.
You guys aren't heroes, from what I hear.
No.
That's to be an L description.
Welcome to 2005, everyone.
Yes. What do you guys think about...
Knox.
Al Gore.
Hello, Polo.
Hello. Oh no, I turned on the volume, but I forgot to... Oh no, I'm hearing myself. It's like Back to the Future.
Back to 2005?
Did you ever watch the cartoon series? I mean, I'm not going to say that it was good. I was 12.
I remember watching the Ghostbusters cartoon series.
The real Ghostbusters?
The real Ghostbusters.
Yeah. What do you mean the other Ghostbusters cartoon that they re-released at the time of the Ghostbusters movie?
Ghostbusters Extreme.
I don't know.
I don't think it was Ghostbusters Extreme, no.
I think there was a Ghostbusters Extreme.
Oh, man. Is that like Lunatics?
It was like new Ghostbusters. Well, new Ghostbusters.
Like NU, like how Linkin Park is new metal?
Yeah. No. I mean, like, actually a
Mike Shinoda is the only one that understands my pain.
New group of busters.
I see.
Are you talking about the female kids. Busters?
No.
That's like the new movie.
I'm talking
new,
about...
New.
That's going to be good.
A
I'm
cartoon series
to.
That came out in 2000? Early 2000s?
Have you not seen it? Just like a group of...
Oh, let's all watch
women.
Ghostbusters.
Yeah. None of them are black, though, so...
Oh. You're not born
done.
Bye, stream.
Yeah. Oh, we're gonna get sued. Thanks, Ryan.
Wait, why are we gonna get
for
sued?
What? By black people?
Yeah.
Just the conglomerate?
The organization.
I know.
Apparently,
wow.
So the dude.
So let's restart the stream.
He was supposed to have. He was supposed to have like a really big
we
role.
We time traveled to 2005. Can we time travel like 5 minutes ago and not just redo it?
Oh boy.
Hello.
I don't know why I'm typing when I could literally just look into the camera and say things. Tiger Crush is just hanging out with us this week. Pike Lord is still out, but I believe he'll be back next week.
So what are we going to do with the seating arrangement here?
Yeah, we'll have to...
We could
put a chair on the table.
As it turns out, I'm bigger and stronger than John, so I'm going to sit wherever I want.
I would prefer that we determine who's bigger and stronger on stream.
Yeah.
I feel like that. I feel like that would really pull in the donations.
I'm not glad we can be a wrestling
match at the beginning of every stream.
I think we should have all kinds of matches at the beginning of every stream.
See, I'm just glad
Hell in a Cell.
The unbearded men now match the bearded men in terms of numbers.
That's true.
Oh man, I don't know if I like this.
So.
Are you gonna shave your beard in protest?
It's gonna grow a second one.
Yeah, I'll grow
a just a smaller, tiny beard on the front of the...
You are licking every part of me.
Polo!
Polo
doesn't have a beard.
No.
He has a coat.
But we still love him. What was I getting at? No, you were talking about seating arrangements. You're just looking at my list of things to do.
Yeah, one of them was
D&D
table.
Yeah, one of them was D&D table. I am, you know, no promises, but I'm going to promise...
Not to make promises.
The moon. No, I'm going to... Obviously, if we have more players, we'll need to upgrade our facilities. And I'll see what I can do about that.
So, you know what we should do? Lobos has...
You're helping. This part of the city is now affected by Greece.
We do have a bacon town. Mm-hmm.
That's in the other city.
Oh, that's right.
This is from a time before bacon.
Oh, that's right. It was
yeah, someone tell us about this. Actually, let's move the city. Can we move it?
Wyvern Slayer Ray! Hi, guys!
Hello,
how's it going?
Wyvern
Slayer,
thank you for rating us.
So
we're talking about Heroes
from
2005.
How many degrees of separation do we have from Bacon Town?
Actually, this might be a fine time to look at the...
The world map, if I mean...
The bacon map?
That's fun for like an hour to set up. There's no such thing as a bacon map.
Could be. We can make it happen.
The chart of the pig's anatomy would be a bacon map.
So...
Oh, it's already on. I thought there was another fold in.
Oh, no, we're good. Thank you, though.
Yep.
So you guys have arrived at Yaramuke, the ruins far here to the northwest.
The city you were most recently at was Tyre. You traveled over the Ringing Mountains and through the forests, and there's that pyramid and the dinosaurs out here in the hinterlands, and you traveled up here to the Dragon's Crown Mountains. This is the Chaksaw, and you went into the forest, and there was a floating thing, and the floating thing flew you all the way over here.
Wait, what?
That happened to me in Arabian Nights.
Though. Well, that's true.
We like, did.
We should play Arabian Nights as soon as we're done.
Flying. Oh, that's right.
Yeah,
we
the
do.
Flying,
the Palace of the Mind, a floating fortress with Zeal's theme music.
That's right, and we went into a portal, right?
You're looking for a portal.
Sorry, well, that wizard was drunk. He doesn't remember the last
room.
Same.
Dude, you have no idea the shit that I see on a weekly basis.
Or that he drinks.
Yeah. I mean, the sad thing is, this specifically says for enhanced mental focus.
Does this have a picture of Shaq on it?
No, but I have had Shaq soda. It's quite good.
Is it?
I don't believe that.
Yeah, I don't
No, it's really good. I had blueberry cream. You had Shaq soda too, right?
I've had two types.
Surprisingly,
I didn't like the blueberry one.
Okay, well.
There was another one that I liked.
Did it change your brain?
Yes.
Is that the tagline?
I just made that up. I thought I was going somewhere
Shaq
with it.
Shaq soda
right?
changed your brain.
I mean, it's a pretty good tagline.
It is. I should sell it to Shaq.
You can use it when he's advertising gold bond powder.
Yeah.
Oh man, I didn't miss something, did I?
Good,
good. I'm glad. I have to make sure that my volume is set such that I won't miss anything.
Don't disappoint Shaq.
That's right. All we need is one big donation from Shaquille O'Neal on the stream to really set you up.
Oh man, true. I ate.
That's not true.
Alright,
I'll finish that joke.
It doesn't matter.
I'll finish that recollection off stream sometime.
I ate the
I did eat at one point in my life.
Ah, that's good.
Those were the days.
Well,
so
Dave, you only ate once.
It could have been a long day.
True.
That sounds like a hip motto for the kids to latch onto. You only eat once. You
only ate once.
You only ate once.
Yo yo. I've seen some people who seem to follow that theory.
Should we put that on a t-shirt? Okay.
Yeah, sleep on it.
So speaking of the ruins of Yaramuke, could someone remind us why the heck we're here?
Sure. Our helpful friend at the Palace of the Mind after he...
Oh, right.
Yeah.
Rock King.
Gembeard.
Yeah, Gembeard. We'll call him that, sure. In exchange for
his name was Faristes.
Faristes. In exchange for helping us get rid of Yarnath from Mentoria's brain, he said, hey... I've got this portal. Go investigate it and tell me what you find. So he flew us there in his flying city, Palace.
That's right.
And dropped us off, and we were heading towards that portal even now.
He even gave you a walkie-talkie.
He did.
Didn't we fight some stuff, too?
Yeah, we fought a fair number of fodder, and...
Oh, that's right. We're in the ruined town.
City.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Our
toughest opponent so far has been a unicorn that strangely appeared.
Oh, I forgot about the unicorn.
Yeah.
Oh, so good.
Up until that, things were going pretty smoothly. We even have a new friend.
Is it a unicorn?
No.
Fuck.
Unicorn was completely not
friendly.
Oh,
yeah, it's the person that you told to get down
on the
ground.
The unicorn. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
The druid killed the unicorn and then ripped its horn off. That's what
ripped
his
head off.
That's
actually.
Right.
Yeah,
and
that,
that's right. And then Marcus and Marvin got a little bicker match about who gets the unicorn horn.
The more important note is that we ran into the Herald of Storm's friends, or a friend. We haven't actually spoken with him. He did seem to behave in a very similar manner. And he tried to rock elements less, but then Harvey's just like, nah. Banished.
Yeah, that was a pretty good banishment.
Well, I mean, it wasn't just.
Yeah,
yeah,
it was about there. A little help from your friend.
Excellent. So yes, you've managed to acquire the services of little slithering Sorin, a lizardman who seems quite obliged to lead you into the Taric's den, into the Sorcerer Queen's former palace. So, following his lead, you guys begin winding your ways down the alleys.
We need some players.
Oh, Paulo, you farted.
Yes, he did.
Right on time.
Yeah, he always does that right about 7.
Yeah! You'd think I would know, like, right after the recap. Paulo, let's go outside.
It's too late now.
The damage is done.
He should have to live with his regrets.
He doesn't regret it. He's a no-on. He's forgotten already.
You're just like just randomly spells bad.
Yeah.
When dogs fart, usually something happens afterwards.
Yeah.
I don't know if you know dogs.
Yeah. Right afterwards, if one goes, your dog farted.
It's true. That's exactly what happens.
The only consequence.
So the lizardman leads you through streets and through alleyways, worn not only by time, but by the ravages of war. Still lots of scars and scorch marks on all of the buildings from when Hamanu's army trampled over the sorceress Siela's forces many, many hundreds of years ago. Until maybe a couple hours later, he brings you around here to the eastern side of the Grand Palace, past the walls, where you can spot, you know, maybe a few Tareks patrolling, but none of them seeming to pay too much attention to the perimeter, which is where this guy has led you. Pigs. Pigs. Stupid. Stupid. Every one of them.
No argument here.
Wise master. Good master. Yes, yes.
So where's your secret entrance?
He points towards the side of this dome over here, where there appears to be grand set of steps leading in, but then also another double set of doors very close to where the mountains butt up against the actual palace itself.
I assume this is blocked from advances.
Yes, it seems to have been where the forces of Sorcerer Queen Sielba made their last stand against Manu's army.
Well, I see two entrances there. Which one?
One not with pigs in front of it. Safer, safer,
together.
Quicker. They are very close. They're literally right around the corner from one another. But the Tareks, such as they are keeping a fierce eye on the horizon, not around the corner. Give me a perception check.
Alright. New die, first roll, 2!
6.
Have you ever considered that maybe it's just you?
I hope not.
Knowing Bill as I do it.
Did anyone get double digits? 10?
I got 8.
Jeffrey, I forgot that you're not playing. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Thanks for coming to my house.
Yeah. Good game, guys.
Lobos, there seems to be a fair number of Tareks in front of this thing of maybe varying sizes. It's kind of weird. There's a bunch of them. There's, you know, most of the ones that you encountered in the street a few hours ago were man-sized, smaller than you, certainly, but there's one that seems big. Bigger than you. Big and chunky.
Alright. I'll point this out to everybody else and say.
Alright.
Particularly big.
Not to Jeff, he's not playing.
Big.
Perhaps a leader of some sort.
Perhaps. Does he look adorned in extra battle gear or anything like that?
As a matter of fact, he's not. He's just sort of...
He's
not fat.
He's chunky. He's got big shoulders.
Big boned.
Big boned.
Big. Got an idea that I need him to get back first.
Looks like there's enough meat on him to carve out another.
No, pull
off.
Put us up.
Didn't pull. What? I guess he ran in and then ran back out to see you because he walked in and I looked away and looked back up and he walked in again.
He's very excited.
Polo.
So I have a question about a magic item that I identified previously. It's a detail that I wasn't given, though.
Yeah.
The feather tokens that can create trees.
Yeah.
What's the range on that?
What is the range on that? That's a really good question.
Didn't think it would ever be relevant, but a giant tree appearing out of nowhere could be a really good distraction in an opposite direction.
It could be. Let's find where my book that has all the rules inside of it is. Found it.
Boop. Or a fireball appearing out of nowhere.
Fireball! Let's
nowhere,
investigate.
From somewhere. I was kind of hoping the tree just kind of pops out of the ground or something. I don't know how it works, though. We'll
hang
out.
On. It's been a few too many weeks. Let's all refresh ourselves on how...
Well, it's definitely one of those obscure magic items you get, and it's like, what the hell am I going to do with it?
Obscure?
With a feather that turns into a tree.
You want to restore the world to its pristine
I can add 3 trees to it.
Yeah. That's 3 trees that weren't there. That's a lot more than most people could do.
Yeah, and they'll die if they're not in the right climate anyway.
In terms of this, isn't that like
a long-term solution?
It's a good percentage of trees for this world, though.
It is.
Like, it is.
That, like, doubled the total.
Oh, man, if you decided to defile, that'd be a super great magical item of,
yeah,
like, power. Just saying, maybe
it's
maybe
guilt free at that point.
It is. It really is. I mean, you're not. It's a zero sum equation. Oh man, I can't wait for Jeff to join the party. Oh, where
what
the heck is this thing?
Make, Jeff?
I don't know, man.
You should make a cleric.
He's got a. Never
cleric.
Mind. There are clerics.
There's
no gods.
Yeah, there are no gods.
Don't you worry your pretty bald head about it. We'll see.
Did you say ballpark?
I said,
yeah.
Like, pretty bald head.
Oh. Don't worry your ballpark Frank about it.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Today's episode has been brought to you by Ballpark Franks. They're good for what ails you.
And they pay
those
more
are the
cost.
Ones that plump when you cook them, right?
That's right, Ryan.
Mm-hmm.
Tell us more.
They're all natural.
They are.
Are they?
I heard they're Shaquille O'Neal's favorite Ballpark Frank.
I hear they go down well with acidos.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I think that we really should have a 7-Eleven buffet sometime.
I think that's the worst.
You
I think
all
that's
nearly
the
died the last time someone ate 7-Eleven.
I don't think that's the definition of buffet. Did I just make this thing up? Where the heck is it?
You might have. It doesn't sound like a very standard issue.
No, it absolutely is. I was like, what are they going to do with this? Okay, I found it. I found it. I found it. You must be outdoors to use this token. You can use an action to touch it to an unoccupied space on the ground. The token disappears, and in its place, a non-magical oak tree springs into existence. The tree is 60 feet tall and has a 5-foot diameter trunk, and its branches at the top spread out in a 20-foot radius.
Okay.
So you can't touch it.
You cannot.
No, it's touch rain. Okay. Well.
Besides, it's a feather.
Yeah.
Like, it's a token with 3 feathers sticking out of it.
I mean, I can figure out ways to throw a feather a distance.
That's true. You could mage hand.
Yeah.
Potentially.
You can't mage hand magic items.
I don't think that you can, no.
Just not to activate them.
Right.
Or you could tie it to another tree and then throw that tree. It's like, shit, where'd that tree come from?
I turn into a snake.
Uh-huh.
We tie it to my back. I slither into the middle of it. Then I activate it, and then I slither back.
The problem is, what if you activate it on top of your body?
Then I'm now a snake in the air. Launched by the
tree.
Yeah.
Anyway,
well, air snake.
Yeah, does it say how high it grows and how fast it grows?
60 feet.
Yeah.
It doesn't
instantaneously.
I mean, I have to imagine it's like the rocket ship in Weird Science, where it just smashes your roof
within one action's duration. I guess.
I'm pretty sure.
So 6 seconds.
I should have bookmarked this. It's gonna take another 10 minutes to find the damn thing.
I'm not gonna do that.
Quick!
Anyway.
Someone cause a distraction.
Or we could not.
Hello.
And be more stealthy going in.
Stealth, huh?
Yeah, we're good at that.
Yeah, I'd imagine it wouldn't be too. Like, how far are we from this entrance?
You're about 100 feet away. You're sort of. So, there's this inner wall that protected the palace. You guys are sort of parked right around here. And he's pointing to this spot right around here.
I have a disguise kit.
Ah, that's right.
Now, what sort of thing, can I make myself look like a pig man?
You can make me look like a pig.
That's true, you're probably better looking. I mean,
better pig
looking.
Closer to pig.
And can't you just turn into a pig?
I mean, I could theoretically, but.
So there we go, two out of the four party members.
I'm not sure the Terex refer to themselves as pig men.
I think I'd literally be
that
a pig.
That might not be very PC.
I would be full pig, not half.
They would just eat him.
They're not like werebores. They just
right.
Yeah, they're kind of like orcs, but they're not orcs. It's Dark Sun. They're totally different.
They probably have bears somewhere, right?
So how far away is the closest pigman to where we would need to walk to get in there?
A little bit further, but not much because of how angles work. So like 120 feet, let's call it.
So they're 120 feet away from where we.
One of the closest one is about 120 feet away.
Actually super close. But it's wide out in the open.
It is, yes. Like I said, they're mostly just watching the courtyard in front of them.
How many did you say there were?
There are 5 of the regular size and one of the big broody ones.
Well,
yes, one fatty. Imminent fatty.
Well, you can try sneaking across, even if it doesn't work. I'm not too impressed by their defenses.
I'm no good at sneaking, but I do my best.
His armor's been jingle jangling.
I rolled like 2 twos last time.
Disadvantage makes it pretty hard when you already aren't good at this.
Well, do we want to. Antara, you and I hang back, prepare spells in case something goes awry. We can
I have something that could maybe aid us. The entrance
cheery disposition?
Yes. The entrance is about 20 feet from where we're at? Or are they
120.
It's 100,
it's 100 away to the door.
Yeah.
How far apart?
They are guarding a different door, slightly further away.
How far apart are they spread? Like, are they just all over the place in that 120 feet? Or are they close together?
They're... Give me a perception check for that information, please.
All right, much better. 18.
They're covering a maybe 40 square foot area. So they're kind of spread out in order to really observe efficiently. But that said, they're not looking left, so they don't see you.
What if we threw the bag over to them?
So I...
Oh, the bag.
Imagine they you just see a bag sitting there. You're like, oh, what's this bag?
Investigate.
And then, whoomp. Then you get eaten, and then your other friends are like, what's this
what
bag? A guy just went in there. That's weird.
It almost worked on you guys.
Well, no, so maybe 2 or 3 get taken out, and we clean up the rest and move on.
I could also create a 20-foot fog cloud, 20-foot cube fog.
That will certainly alert them something's wrong.
But imagine there's a bag.
Not the weather for that.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. With a pig man.
I don't know.
And then there's a tree that springs out of the bag.
It's like a Rube Goldberg device. We're getting rid of 6 enemies.
And most of our magicals.
Yeah! That's what
single
I like.
Single marble perfect. Rolls in front of the champion.
Let's try walking across. They notice us and we'll liberate them. They don't seem exactly that threatening based on our previous encounter.
Do we want to hang back for spells in case? I mean, you're Mr. Tactics over here. I'm fine to go out guns blazing.
I think I'd actually prefer that in this case. That way we're closer together. It'd be a shame if they manage to sneak across and then we try to follow and that's when things go wrong.
Well, let me go first, because if trouble's going to spot me, then, well, spot anyone, it's going to be me.
Fair point.
All right. I'm going to try and creep as close to this inner wall... Heading towards that set of double doors.
Lizard man gives you sort of a curious look as you step past. Fat roll is definitely in effect. What's your stealth check?
It's a 9.
9? Someone else following this guy?
If he hadn't immediately gotten caught, and Torius turns to the lizard and says, come on, let's go. So I guess we're both going at the same time.
Yep.
My stealth check first. Pretty good. That is a 19 for me.
Wow.
Gotcha.
I'll go last.
You rolled a 1.
Oh.
He sneezed. Alright, let me find a map.
Yeah.
Alright.
That's the problem with stealth in D&D. Someone always rolls crap if you try to do something in a group.
Well,
it's happened every single
it's
time.
It's actually just the same problem that, like, stealth multiplayer games have, which is more chances to fail.
Yeah.
Like Payday 2, it's a great game, but if friends are trying to do stealth and you're not built for stealth, well... Not a lot you're going to be doing besides messing shit up.
Yeah, I tried playing that game, and it was just 45 minutes of being shot at by 500 policemen.
Yeah. It was not a fun game.
Oh, so America.
Dang.
Burn.
For social commentary, FOXHOUND _ on Twitch TV. Not that I don't disagree with you.
We come in hard. Jack's going to pull his sponsorship.
Yeah, he hates black people. Oh, that's how we get famous. We have to call out super famous, super vain people. Yeah. I hate you, Kanye. You're the worst.
You had balls good, wait, too. Kanye, he might actually come fight
oh
us.
Oh my god, do you remember that one time that Lotex and UA Bowl boxed and UA Bowl beat the shit out of him? Yeah. Oh my god.
I heard that Tom Cruise is quitting Scientology.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
That's good to hear. I like watching his movies and would like to not feel guilty watching
them. Yeah, exactly.
Did you watch Lobos Edge of Tomorrow after I strongly recommended it last time?
No.
Oh, you should really watch it. It's super good. If you haven't watched Edge of Tomorrow, it's fucking fantastic.
Is that a recent movie?
It was last year.
It's a serious suggestion.
Wait,
no, it's an absolutely serious suggestion. It's a... Yeah.
It's like a futuristic... And there's like towers of shit that are like...
Wow, that doesn't sound futuristic.
He does have towers in a lot of his movies.
There's like energy...
There is energy.
...towers or whatever.
Mm.
And there's like different sectors...
I think, are you talking about the Hunger Games?
No, this is Tom Cruise. That might be Oblivion I'm thinking of.
Yes, I think you're talking about Oblivion. I have not seen Oblivion. I heard it was not very good.
Okay.
I'm talking about Edge of Tomorrow, which is him in Gears of War. If that rings any bells.
See, I thought you were talking about my
new the new ones, so you get all
there.
The polo aggro.
Oh, I know.
Edge of Tomorrow. Okay.
It's really good. It's like a super smart, really well-written sci-fi movie.
You guys just kill these fucking pigs.
I'm trying.
No, you're not. You're talking about it for tomorrow.
Listen, you okay, realize so. We got actually started about 20 minutes early on.
Yep.
We're all dead.
I mean, I like your attitude so far. You coming in here and you're like, we're gonna do things my
like, okay,
way.
Okay, I'm not even in the game yet. Alright, guys, here's how this is going down.
Here's the game plan.
Alright, so what we've got here is this is the area that they were guarding. And then here is the door that Slithery McSlitherson, actually, he has a name, but no one's asked what it is. And no one ever. It does, it's a good name. I like saying it. In the mirror when I practice. It's not Chaksad. It's a different race. You're super racist. You don't even know the difference between reptiles and bugs. Although those are definitely condescending names. So you guys are over here near him, although it's actually just Marcus and Antoria. The other two of you are just sort of...
You're separate from
we no longer exist.
And then...
Combat and some minis, and let's get some initiative.
At least we didn't call ourselves a squad of stealth.
I think the Over Council would have laughed you out of the room.
They should have laughed us out of the room for the name we did give ourselves. There was no more.
They rolled a really bad check to identify that the Sandy Snatch was not an actual tavern. In fact, they sent guards. I think someone did a really good check.
Yeah.
To convince them of the truth
of
this.
Yeah. I remember the same thing.
I would have guessed that came from you, actually.
Yep.
I wonder
if we get back there, the entire town's going to be convinced it's some kind of secret tavern.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, it's invite only.
You know,
yeah.
Underground tavern.
Where was the first town we were in? Because I have in my journal.
Altrak.
Yeah.
I have in my journal, there's guard that I gave money to. I'm like, hey, give me, you know, keep you up to date on.
The guard thinks we're all dead, bro.
Yeah, then you just left. Like,
yeah.
It was like, thanks, buddy.
You guys did leave.
We
I mean, they were planning to come back. They just got captured.
Yeah.
Right
here,
Altra.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, Tarn. Tarn, Rotund's guard. I gave him 30 gold for his help. Talk to him in the future.
Well, so,
we're gonna go back to Tarn. He's gonna be like the
optional
mission
objective. Optional quest objective failed.
Yeah.
No, he's probably got tons of data for you now. Oh,
no,
I've been
I wanna
snooping around for the past 2 months. I can't. I've got so much to tell you.
I want to believe that Tarn is like, you know,
spy master now,
or you know, or the leader, and he's like, you know, that 30 gold really helped me.
Yeah, that boosted me up the ranks.
Got me to quit the death sticks and
also,
move on with my life.
Also, we've got a nice plot of land we haven't gone to yet.
That's true.
Yeah.
No one has.
Pretty sure there's just a bird and a mouse on it.
Yeah.
There's also two ghosts.
Ghosts? Oh.
Oh, that's right.
No, not here.
I'm nightmare right now. I was like, what?
Here's another good...
Are you scared of ghosts?
I've actually got a... Something in here that says codename Jeremiah. That's me. Marcus is Taurus. I think that's when we were doing our drinking game.
No, because
I
have
a code name
here.
Jermaine. Jarvis, yeah.
Do you guys play Dungeons and Dragons without me?
That was for the drinking game.
That was the lost session.
We should have code names for.
Yeah, and we did.
Oh, the drinking games where you're trying to.
And that's how.
Because he got the wild magic where he couldn't get drunk.
Uh-huh.
That's right.
And that's when I picked up shit wrong.
And you first encountered the lady Gladiator.
Yes.
Yeah.
I just don't remember her name. I don't think she ever gave it.
I think she punched it out of your skull by accident.
Yeah. She punched you a lot.
Yeah.
And then she dipped you and kissed you.
Yeah, she did. In the heat of the moment.
That was pretty good. I mean, you had just done the city a great service.
Yeah. By kissing her?
No, by assisting the king in his great victory.
That's when we saved the king.
I think Tithian did most of the heavy lifting in that fight.
Yeah, you sure did, according to him.
He must have the best PR ever.
Himself.
Marcus, what is your initiative?
Oh. Five.
Five? I'm going to put you right back where I found
you. Not there, people also roll, I assume?
They're there enough, I guess, right?
What?
He was asking if he should roll initiative since he's not there, but they're there enough, right?
He's. I assume you're.
Shut the corner.
Are you?
Yeah.
Even if you're turning and running away, I want your initiative roll. You're definitely cognizant. What is your roll, Barrett?
17.
17. That's a pretty good roll,
yeah.
Marvin.
That is
23.
23. Goodness, Antoria.
17. What's your dex mod?
0.
Honestly, it's on the head.
Yeah. You have a dex mod of 2.
Yes.
He has everything.
Yeah, he does.
No, not everything.
He's probably got, like, negative strength.
Yep.
Charisma.
Yeah.
All right, well, the Terrics are going there, and then the big pig is going to go there.
What about my lizard buddy?
That's a great question. Marvin, it's your turn.
So, I'm going to fireball.
Dinner plate.
It looks like everyone there.
Yeah.
Well, are these guys in? Is this inside?
I think it goes through walls, though, right?
It goes around
walls. It doesn't go through walls.
Is this like an open air balcony thing, or what's going on here?
So those are stairs out in front. It is open air, but it's 20 feet up.
Well, it's a 20 foot radius fireball. It should be able
then,
to.
Then, yeah, it's fine.
Yeah.
Okay, so I kill everyone, basically.
Yeah.
Alright. Do you want me to recharge
including
my
wall? Merit?
No, not just
polo.
Everyone here.
Okay, good.
And polo, yes.
Yeah.
Polo. Polo resists fire.
Yeah. Polo has immunity to all damage.
He was the lich back when there was a lich.
Yeah.
He played the part of Yarna.
You did such a good job, Polo.
What a good job. Why do I smell peanut butter?
30. Because I got M&M's over here.
Oh, man.
Oh.
Jealous.
Do you want some?
No. I prefer to just train.
That seems the wrong color. Not Reese's Pieces?
Got it.
All the Reese's Pieces imitating
peanut butter?
Yeah. Well, peanut butter M&M's.
Yeah.
Not peanut M&M's. Peanut butter M&M's.
I'm trying to count here. 33?
What's my save?
16. Or half. Oh, do you want me to do wild magic? Return?
Hell yeah.
It's going to be a really lackluster fight if he just incinerates the wall instantly.
That's kind of what happened to the last fight, actually, though. These guys are kind of foddery so far.
Nice. I cast Mirror Image.
Are you cereal?
Yeah.
That's fantastic. Well, I'm not going to go print out more minis of you, unfortunately, so we'll just have to
pretend. Actually need them for Mirror Image the way it works these days.
How does it work?
No, but they're like shimmering around you.
But they stay in your square, though.
I know. It's like it's a lot like the WoW version.
Yeah, just it cancels out hits. Every time it cancels out a hit, it gets weaker and it's less likely
to
cancel.
Is it 5?
Whoa.
I think it's 3, actually. We'll look it up between now and when you get attacked, but it's pretty good, especially when you didn't have to actually cast it yourself.
Yeah.
Do we smell bacon?
Give me a perception check. Okay. Smell base.
Alright. I'm not a bear now, so I don't get a bonus to it.
Good.
17.
No! You don't smell bacon?
After the fireball goes off?
No! You're 120 feet away. Get a hold of yourself.
Polo doesn't like this.
After
Polo,
the
I'm sorry
goes
for yelling.
Off,
I pull the
I'll
bacon
say,
out of my pack.
guard duty's up. You're all fired.
Is this an aspect of your character?
No.
Yes.
Doing yes, random things. Yes.
One-liners. Yes. Although it's been a while.
Yeah.
I have one really planned for the ice storm.
I can't wait.
Yeah.
You should cast ice storm sometime.
Guard duty's up. You're all iced. That,
I hope it's just first name. Is everybody freeze?
No, it's ice to meet you.
But then I got a workshop.
Antoria, it's your turn.
All right, Antoria turns briefly to his lizard friend and says, "Stay behind me." Moves in front of him.
What language did you say that in?
Draconic.
Are you sure? It's real quickly. Did you remember to say it in Draconic?
I'll repeat it in Draconic. It's not that long of an
episode. I don't know. You can only say one thing your turn.
Anyway. Moving on.
Yeah, yeah.
Antoria touches his fingers briefly to his head and stares at the big fellow getting advantage on his next attack roll. And then shoots a firebolt at him.
Would you say that someone has changed your brain? Was it an old man in a mysterious ceremony?
Yes.
Who was secretly Shaquille O'Neal?
My character's actually just gonna be Shaq.
Wow, double four. You probably miss with a 12.
12 does not hit.
Wow, great psychic power.
You're welcome. That'll be $9.99.
That is my turn.
Should ask Cleo about that one.
Your lizard friend is terribly excited. He's just sort of dancing in place, trying. Actually, very deliberately to stay exactly behind you, regardless of which way you turn and twist.
Alright.
Barret, it's your turn.
Alright. I don't think I want to burn my bear form for this, so I'm going to run out from where we're at and produce a flame and throw it at somebody. Throw it at the big guy, I guess. What always happens to me? What?
I was complaining about rolling double
four. I rolled a three. I miss as well. Yeah.
All right, the big guy rushes. I can't see. Everyone's too diagonal.
Barrett, Victoria, Marcus.
I think Barrett's closest, so he's gonna rush with Barrett.
Oh boy. Did he get there in one
he's
turn?
He's easily got enough movement to get over there.
If he dodges out of the way, he'll hit a wall and get stuck.
Is he like that?
He's the butcher.
And then I can hit him.
Like galloping?
He does. He's got like big ape arms.
Oh man.
And with those big ape arms.
Been missing leg or missing leg day.
I mean, his legs are kind of beefy too.
Okay.
But his arms are lanky. And with those arms, he takes a couple of swings at our bearded friend here. By that, I mean Barret.
Barret.
AC's 15.
AC of 15 will hit with both arms. But then he actually leans forward and takes a chomp out of you as well. So you take a total of 16... No, excuse me.
I thought you were about to say 60.
No, I didn't say 60. Those are some badass arms. That's like the jacks of all the Terex.
Like the Shaquille O'Neal.
It's like the Shaquille O'Neal of the Terex.
The Shaq Fu.
You take 20 points of claw damage.
Is this total?
20 points of both claws.
Gotcha.
15 is your AC?
Yeah.
His jaws just snap just short of your chest.
Sweet.
Give me a perception check, Barret.
Sure.
You're bleeding.
11.
11.
Coming out of your stomach.
You can see that the... No, excuse me. That's not true. Never mind.
I can't see.
Yeah, nothing... nothing.
Giant
I realized that the thing that I was about to say was factually inaccurate, so never mind. Sorry. I'm not as all-knowing as everyone has always thought that I am.
So,
I don't know.
Total of
20.
20 damage.
Yes.
That actually hurt quite a bit.
Marcus, it's your turn.
Out of curiosity, what's your hit point? I don't know what. I don't know.
Like, my max HP is 72.
Minus 6.
Okay.
But he gets an extra pool when he shifts.
Yeah.
Because he gets all of that form's HP.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
Barret is sort
but
of.
Still,
right,
so
20 the tank.
Is pretty considerable.
It's not nothing.
Finish off
it's a good
these probably almost dead things. Alright. Take a strike.
Attacking Barrett, I see.
Yes.
That's the way it goes.
20.
That hits.
Let's see the damage first. 12 damage.
He explodes.
Oh, wow. Chris rolled a crit.
Oh, well.
So he double looks. I just keep stabbing.
Well,
corpse
you. You kill his blood. Okay. Like, his blood jumps up into the air, and then you, like, Zorro, like, and it dissolves.
Carry okay. Your name in it.
He's
up
there. Well, then I would
goodbye,
like
blood.
To short bow this guy as my second attack.
Oh, wow. All right.
Probably
okay.
Yes. Plus 6. 20.
That hits.
Again.
Just like...
Like
that one.
And it's I never use this thing. 1d6 plus 4. 7 damage total.
He should not have done that.
No job of
fair enough to push it through.
It should have.
And I can do
but he's
5
not
more
smart
steps of movement. So there.
Okay.
I'm done.
Wonderful. Well, there's no more Terex. Marvin, you're up. Intori, you're on deck.
I'm going to cast Firebolt and use my Tides of Chaos to gain advantage.
Hut-choo!
Bless you.
Hut-choo!
Yikes.
Bless you.
I got one more.
Nope.
Ah, it's the worst.
I spoke too soon.
17, I think.
I'm sorry, what's happening?
Yeah, 17.
To hit?
Yeah.
The big guy?
Yeah.
Yeah, that hits.
As if I was going to attack one of the other big guys.
I don't know.
Marcus is right there.
12.
Maybe you've got like a billiard shot where if you bank it off of Marcus, it deals more damage.
If you want to give me something like that, I could...
I'll think about it.
Okay. That would be cool. Yeah. I don't know what that was for, but...
Shake on it.
Okay.
I thought I was doing my Telak impersonation, but I forgot to do what Terran's hands look like, which is pink and scaly, and they only have 3 fingers.
12 points of fire damage. And that's all I've got.
That's good. That's fine. Antoria, you're up. Barrett, you're next.
Antoria touches his forehead again, briefly staring at the big guy, and then shoots another fireball at him.
Okay.
Natural 20. So, oh, I assume that hits. He's going to take some fire damage.
Yes, sir.
Let's see. Oh, I have this much dice. There it is. That will be 9, 10. Jeez, 12 damage. That's it.
12 damage, fire.
12 damage, that's it.
Well, what a crit.
Yes, indeed.
You hit him. 12 out of 4.
He missed again. I was going to think your character actually was just miming and didn't have any powers at all.
The Sauron behind you continues to be terribly excited. He's sort of clutching the back of your robes. Barrett.
Alright.
The guys go next.
I am going to turn into a bear like I should have done last turn.
Good job.
Yeah. And then I'm going to bite and claw him back.
Taste his own medicine.
Dark die. Well, the black die will be the claw.
God,
terrible. Terrible.
Bad bear.
Does a...
No.
14 hit.
No.
Oh,
good
wait.
Turn, Bill.
15. But, sorry.
Well, it was 14, so no.
So, yeah.
Read your character
it's
sheets.
Plus 7. I can't do math. Simple math.
Yeah, we've established that over the many months.
Yes.
It usually takes you 3 tries to add 2 numbers together.
Anything else?
Am I good at the fast? Fast guy. Alright, anyway. Both meth, so nah.
Hello.
I'm just gonna...
between place both.
I'm gonna roar at him.
I can't
handle it. I'm gonna see if it smells like bacon yet.
Give me a perception check.
Oh wait, I'm a bear now, so I get advantage. 18.
No! Not yet.
Okay.
He's gonna sidestep you and swing at Marvin.
Uh-oh. Oh no.
Does he move?
He doesn't.
Okay.
He hits with his claws, but not with his bite.
Alright, so I gotta roll something here. Just
okay.
One hit?
Two hits.
Alright, so the first one.
Yes.
I must roll.
Oh, that's right, mirror image.
Six or higher.
Game mechanics.
The thing to the duplicate. Alright, so it attacks a duplicate. My AC is 10 plus. No, it's probably. It's 13 AC for the duplicate.
Okay, well, hit both of those.
Yeah, so the first duplicate goes away. Oh, unless he's got something like blind sight. If he relies on senses other than sight,
he does.
Can perceive illusions as false.
He relies on senses other than sight.
Alright, so. I don't think it actually
does anything.
Does anything.
All right.
Yeah, it's just a case.
Then the mirror image comes back. It's like Braid.
It just beats the shit.
Only without the smarmy attitude.
Hey, I like that game.
I like it too, but I'm still calling out Jonathan Blow in order to accumulate internet stardom.
Yeah, come on, Jonathan Blow.
Yeah.
Where's your other game?
Quit programming standing
seriously.
Up.
The Witness, more like the... Never coming out this.
Yeah.
I haven't witnessed that game being released yet.
No, that's bad.
There you go.
They're both
pretty good. I'm really excited for The Witness.
Yeah, I pre-ordered it. I can't wait to play. Anyway, you take some damage. Oh my god. Fuck.
Yeah, you're dead.
No, he's not. I really wish that he... Damn it. I rolled a lot of ones.
I have Shaquille O'Neal watching over me. he's just like, nope.
Spirit
basketball bounces off the guy's head.
I hope Shaq Fu 2 has summons in the spirit of the different Shaq characters.
That's right, you have Shazam.
Or yeah, Steel.
Yeah. Or Shazam.
Yeah.
Is the only one I know.
Steel is the one where he was John Steel, the Superman derivative character that wears a steel suit and has a giant hammer and travels in a van to fight crime. It was worse than Kazam. Kazam is in a boombox. Anyway, you take 11 points of damage.
Why do you know that?
I saw it in theaters.
Because he knows it's Shaq trivia.
I like comics. It used to be that you didn't always get comics. You had to really want to see Nick Cage starring David Hasselhoff in Spanish. Anyway, Marcus, it's your turn. I've lived a good life.
Have you?
No.
No way stared off.
I'm sorry for what I've done.
Let's see. One attack is a 22.
That hits.
Wham. I'll do damage. I'm just going to do these one at a time. 9. 14 damage.
Oh. Alright.
Alright, attack number 2 is also a hit, 24. Ooh, double sixes, and that is 15 damage.
15 damage. He is looking pretty bloody.
Sure, I'll attack again.
Yeah!
Oh no!
And a natural one.
Oh, no. Natural one! Critical failure! I was supposed to revise the...
No, number one!
Number one! Double one fumble!
That's the worst one. For
attack hits ally in range.
Oh,
Jesus Christ.
I would argue there is no ally in range.
I'd argue
he could strike through, maybe.
Are you... You're one square away from Barrett. This is a large creature, so I think that absolutely you take a sideways swipe and you accidentally hit the bear.
Okay.
The bear.
You don't have to re-roll.
Yeah, that's right, I don't have to re-roll. 7 damage.
Alright.
I was supposed to revise the magic fumbles chart like a month ago.
So does a fumble like that end my attack?
Yes.
Okay.
So did you intentionally name your character something that starts with the word bear?
No, actually, I didn't.
I don't know if I believe that.
I do.
I disbelieve the illusion.
I'm pretty sure.
I didn't start with bears.
You were gunning for it the whole
time. You were working your way there.
No, because Dark Sun has weird monsters, and he wasn't sure what animals he'd be able to turn into.
That is true.
It just turned out that we don't like saying the word Kraj every single time, so now he's a mountain bear.
Yeah.
Which is fine, because Krajs actually have, like, weird Cthulhu mouths, and they're not nearly as adorable.
Oh.
That's actually kind of a theme. The EP just kind of has a Cthulhu kind of thing going on here. Yeah. Just random tentacles and spines on its back.
It's not even a...
It's like an ordinary monster.
It's not even a variant of a Clara then,
huh? Clara, excuse me. No, I can come up with bears.
But...
Anyway, and Marvin, it's your turn. What?
Oh, yeah, it is Marvin, sorry, yeah.
Yeah.
Confuse me.
Full name is Barrett Kashir.
That's right, he does have a last name.
Yeah.
I'm going to Magic Missile, the big guy.
Excellent.
Pew, 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 pew. 1, 3, 4, 7.
Hello. 47.
And can I recharge my Tides of Chaos for Wild Magic?
Yes.
Okay. Before doing that, I guess I can't do that right now.
Is anyone else going to have a poison?
No, thank you.
No, thanks.
Alright.
45. I cast levitate on myself.
So long.
See ya.
Let's get a prompt. Yeah, there we go. Good, good. Ooh.
Is he within? Well, I guess if I move out of his range, he can attack me, right?
Yeah, you're levitating.
You can. He's got reach, so he's got quite the range.
I'll stand where I am. But I'll use my bonus action.
You're gonna stand or stay? I'm sorry, I just misheard you and I wasn't sure which verb you used. Because you can't stand because you're floating.
What?
You're levitating.
Are you telling me that you can't control levitate so that such that you're not actually applying upward force on yourself?
I don't know. I don't know how levitate works.
Herbie will figure this out.
Yeah, yeah.
And I'm gonna
that would seem a shame to cast levitate on yourself and then not be forced to levitate for however long.
Let's see. One creature or object of choice that you can see rises vertically up to 20 feet and remains suspended
up
there for the duration.
Up to 20 feet. So you could say 0 feet.
I would say
an unwilling target can make a constitution saving throw if they like, by the way. The target can only move by pushing or pulling against a fixed object or surface. You can change the target's
This happened to a horse.
You
I
can change
now.
The target's attitude by up to 20 feet in either direction on your turn. If you are the target, you can move up or down as part of your move. Otherwise, you must use your action to move the target.
So I'm standing on the ground.
No, if you want to be, then set up to 20 feet, so zero is a power.
Does he control the wild magic, though, or is it wild and controlled by some...
No,
he
especially can control it, yes.
Okay.
Okay. I'll also expend 5 sorcery points to regain a level 3 slot.
Keen.
As a bonus action.
Got it.
And that's all I've got.
And Toria.
All right. And Toria gestures with his wand and sends another firebolt over. This time, no psychic hocus pocus. No, I know 4 doesn't hit, so we can just skip that.
Barrett.
All right. Fight
and claw.
Yeah, really tearing it up.
Fight will be in black.
You're contributing to this team.
Oh. Well, the claw's gonna hit.
Like, so
you might as well get your knife out and go.
I mean, claw
not
much
you can do in roll fours.
Does a
just take the guy prisoner. I'll deal plenty with the knife.
Yeah.
Does a 25 hit?
25 does hit.
Jeepers.
I don't want to waste my real spells on this thing. He's probably almost dead.
Of course, I rolled.
You don't want to use a magic missile.
No, it probably does less damage.
7.
Yeah,
7 piercing magic damage.
7 piercing magic damage.
And a procs wild magic.
Yeah, I don't know magic.
Excellent, it's his turn. Everyone give me a perception check.
Hey, I didn't roll a 4. I got a 14.
16.
I also got 14.
12.
Everyone notices that actually some of the cuts and nicks that he's taken seem to reform. That's what reforming sounds like. And then he continues his onslaught against Marvant.
Oh, God. What?
And hits with a claw and with the bite.
So if he's levitating and he gets hit, does it just, like, send him, like...
It does.
Yeah. Well,
does it really?
Well, he's on the ground, though. He chose not to fly.
Well, he's not levitating.
Yeah.
But if he was, then yes.
If he was, then yes.
But wait, I want to get hit out of the way. Like,
then
I'm on the ground, but there's no gravity applied to me, so if someone were to push me,
yeah,
I can't...
Still,
yeah,
like,
still
he
go.
Still don't have... There's no gravity, so he's not stuck. To
yes.
Makes sense.
Okay,
yeah.
So you get hit by the claw, and then he snaps his teeth into open air.
Good.
Good. You take 12 points of damage.
You sail northward.
How far back?
My psycho shield goes off. I take 0 points of damage.
Oh,
damn!
Psycho shield.
So then, I guess you stay in place.
No, the force still hits me.
Okay. That's fair. Yeah, impact.
The damage goes to the other field too, so that makes sense.
Do you want to roll a direction for him to fly?
Well, no, he's just going to do Newtonian movement.
How far back is the question?
Three squares.
Okay.
Then that guy gets pushed back too, right?
He's not levitating.
Yeah, but...
And he's much stronger than you are.
I don't think that's...
Marcus, it's your turn.
That's exactly how
you're up next.
I'm going to attack more.
Can levitate do everything?
Oh! 20. It's a 29 hit.
It does.
Yes. All right, let's see.
See, I want to roll crit damage like that. I'm pretty sure we'll higher on 40. Yeah. You're on iron 40
damage.
So
20 damage!
Yes.
Describe for us your killing blow against this monstrosity.
I'm so excited.
I am excited. Well, he's busy swiping at Marvin over here. So insert my greatsword into his backside.
I like the pigs from
right
Bloodborne.
The spine.
Oh, different than the pigs from Bloodborne then.
Oh, yes, slightly different than that.
I don't know. You can do whatever you want
in
life. I can
insert it through.
It's your call.
Fine.
I asked.
It can be both.
Yeah.
Why am I dying? Hurry up, dessert!
I stab him in the back. And I harvest the bacon.
Yes. Give me a harvest check.
Get all bacon. Sword insertion. I'm gonna do 12.
And get three black
bottles.
I found a red brooch.
I break the brooch.
You get a. Life gem, a blood gem.
I eat the blood gem.
Is he just Geo too?
He is. Although that reminds
out of the way, Brendan.
That reminds me, I need to put together that rotating DM game set.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, what?
The rotating DM. Like, I want to do another like updated speedrun,
yeah.
But I also want to do a different game. That's past the Dungeon Master.
Okay.
Where everyone at the table has, like, it just keeps going around. It's kind of, it's actually inspired by Drunk Souls,
mm-hmm.
where the controller keeps
okay.
moving around the table.
Is this where the DM, you say one word and then the DM changes?
No.
It's not,
that
it's not quite that
well
fast.
Okay.
That would be crazy.
No,
yeah,
we get about halfway through the table.
No, how do we think that would go? Quick, let's start, go.
Penis. Fuck!
That's two words.
That's not
you're
the word
disqualified.
I was gonna say.
Start.
Terribly.
Good. Done. Terribly good.
Penis. Terribly.
You're not playing. No.
Ferret.
Terribly good ferret.
He said penis. You're fucking leaving him out.
Penis. So, the reason I say penis...
he said penis fuck, to be fair.
Let me give you a little backstory, because I was thinking that's what Lobos would say to, like, end... the chain, because he always says something like completely non sequitur, and so when you called me out, that was the first thing on my head.
Uh-huh.
So I think we should try again.
I think we should move on.
Yeah. Iron was level.
Give me a chance to redeem myself. Right.
Later.
Okay.
We should probably get inside before the commotion draws anyone else out here.
Agreed.
Let's
do it. Oh, wait, no, I don't say that. I go, rah, rah, rah.
This is actually a little
charge
of
close.
Underneath it says agreed.
I guess we're all heading this way.
Beard
yes.
Right.
The lizardman scampers up to the door. Oh, masters, so powerful, so strong. Amazing, amazing.
Burr.
Good job, good job, good job.
I will. I'll do an investigate check to see if there's any traps visible on the door.
I said
sure.
We just let him open the door.
let's see. Investigate for trappies. That's pretty good, probably. That is a 20.
There don't appear to be any traps. However, the doors look good and stuck. The lizardman rushes over to a crack in the wall. A little tiny crack in the wall, actually. And says, come on, come on, come on. Inside, inside. And then disappears inside.
How big is this crack?
It's not very big, is the
okay.
thing.
Can I smash the
so, the lizardman is small-sized.
Yeah.
You're not that big.
I'm walking up to it. Can I go in?
The door
I'm going to try and stuff myself in as a bear.
No.
The door
I mean, give me a
crack,
stuff check.
All right.
Give me, it's going
to
be,
it open,
actually, it's
going to
be acrobatics.
Not sure
probably
what
a better bet than trying to smash down the stone wall.
I need to look that would be
up.
Noisy. Let's see if we can fool or
what's
push
that based
the sword.
On? Dex.
Dex.
By the way,
right.
I got
11.
Half
11
points missing.
All right, you shove your bare head into the hole, and
oh, no.
That's about it.
We can rest once we're inside, hopefully.
Really? I
hope so.
Long rest?
Maybe not that long.
Oh.
I'm gonna do my best to try and get these doors to budge.
Okay.
Is there any like handles or anything? Or
there are.
There are.
Yep.
Does it say push or pull anywhere?
You can't read.
That's true.
You're like the dog from the
like,
internet.
Does it seem obvious which way the direction?
They look like pull doors.
Okay.
But they also look busted.
Busted. In what war?
They're 500 years old and there was a war.
What are these doors?
And these guys didn't move past like Greece in terms of technology.
They're wood doors?
There's no libraries, by the way. They're not made of wood, no. They're made of stone.
None we know about anyway.
I mean, there are libraries. They're just not common social fixtures.
Yeah,
right. Most people just want food.
They're not public facilities.
I'll give them one real good tug and try not to dislocate my shoulders.
Okay.
That's a 27.
27? Handle pops off.
Damn it!
Did it.
Well, looks like we're going to have to either make that hole bigger or...
What happens if I try and slam into the doors using my bare girth?
Give me a girth check.
Yeah, I don't know what to roll for that.
Decidedly strength.
Worthless in everything we've done.
Straight up strength?
If
yeah.
If get in here, 20. It will definitely
20?
Surprise
yeah.
them.
The doors pop open.
No. So I point to Barrett charging the door.
I barrel through.
Oh my god!
Wait,
Phil made an actual bear pun!
Oh no.
I'm writing this day on the calendar.
I totally missed it.
I said I barreled through.
Oh.
Mm-hmm. I think I actually might have done that one before.
I would not be surprised.
Don't tell. Brendan's so excited.
Yeah.
No. Don't.
We're always searching for bear puns.
Really
no, you! You specifically are always stretching for bear puns.
I'm on British.
And not very far.
Alright. Well, shall we go in?
No, don't do that. That's a terrible mistake.
I leave.
Goodbye.
We saved, what, like a room here? Instead of going in the front way, we went in the side way?
The front is like... collapsed in though, right?
This is
something like that.
Gone?
No.
Or is this here?
I mean, it still exists. That's
but now
the front entrance to this area that you're in.
So it's covered by the fog of war.
Yes.
Okay.
Please leave it there. Don't worry, this area isn't terribly big. This area leads to a foyer where the lizardman is still waiting for you. As a matter of fact, there is a double set of wooden doors in here that look relatively intact. Good. Down below. Pig lord. Big creepy crawlies.
Well,
hold on.
If something were to happen to you, I'm not saying there would be, but do you know of any traps I should be aware of? Or anything in this area we should be aware of?
Bunch of question marks here over the lizardman's head.
Question.
He sort of looks concernedly to Antoria.
He's asking what is up ahead of us directly through those doors, do you know?
Oh, scorpions.
Scorpions.
Oh, huge, big.
And this is the route you've recommended for
us.
Oh,
we can get around them. Get around them. No problem. Hey, promise.
Get around
them,
you haven't seen our...
And get around them, you mean us kill them? Then what do you mean?
I mean...
How do we get around
them? Would be no problem for such majestic lords as yourselves, but...
Understood, of course.
Yes,
but how do you plan on us getting around them other than that?
Well, go around. No problem.
Insight check?
Sure.
That's actually a 20.
As lizards go, he's on the up and up.
I don't know what to make of that. Okay.
Alright. He's telling the truth, is what he's saying.
Yeah. At least as much as lizards ever can, apparently.
Yeah.
By that description. Well, scorpions. Alright.
What are these, benches?
Yes.
Marcus.
Do we want to take a 10-minute rest here?
Or...
It collapses.
Bear will sit on the bench.
Oh, no!
Do we hear anything, like, any commotion?
There's a crash as Marcus falls on his ass.
Before that, and after, I guess.
Give me a perception check.
Yeah.
Polo. Polo.
15?
15? No, as a matter of fact, you don't hear too much.
As much as I would like to rest here, we're not really very far inside. They're looking for whoever killed their friends outside. They'll probably get to the now open door before too long. Maybe we should go a little further in before we try that.
It's fine by me.
Right?
Can I nudge the door shut, or are they splintered completely?
I mean...
stone.
They're stone.
Oh, well.
You're not that strong.
You can attempt to close them, certainly, but they're pretty busted from both age and from the impact. So they're not going to close to nearly the degree of stuckness that they were before.
Not worth it.
I prefer to keep our escape routes open.
Yeah,
all part of my plan.
I'll investigate on the doors to see if they have any traps on them.
Sure.
21.
Oh, as a matter of fact, there does seem to be a very rudimentary kind of tripwire attached to these.
Tripwire attached to the door?
Yeah.
Okay.
Point it out to the well.
It appears to be like suspended on the other side of it, such that if you were to open them, then the door itself would actually set the wire off.
Okay.
Did you point that out to the rest of us, or do you?
I was just about to. I mean, I did just.
Or do you keep it to yourself in classic Antoria fashion?
Yeah, it's not really.
Well, no, because I wanted
Marvin,
to point
you
that
go
out.
Through this.
I wanted to point that out to our lizard friend.
Yeah, well, he's pointing. Antoria points it out to everyone.
Okay.
It seems to be a tripwire there.
I'll turn to lizard friend inquisitively.
Yes.
Something you want to tell us about this,
You're not speaking Draconic, right?
No.
Okay.
No, I'm speaking in...
Question marks.
Antoria more politely, though, translates. He asks the question, but he's not being blunt or rude about it.
Scurries over to the wall and disappears through another crack.
Wait.
Doors swing open.
Alright. Huh. There we are.
Yeah.
But now
real convenient we didn't learn about it until brush them off.
You might want to leave him alone.
Marcus goes to high five the lizard.
They have high fives on Athens.
Yeah.
Now the lizard.
They just invent
we can see inside, right?
The level of
you can.
Trust you've put in this creature astounds me.
It's paid off so far.
Watch Lord of the Rings.
And for that matter, the lizard man is kind of strange as well. there we go.
Alright. So it's just like another door.
There's another double set of doors, but there's also a large
circular wall in front of you.
What do you know about this area?
Oh, scorpions.
Inside the next door,
I see. Yeah. Pigs bring them in. Torture.
So where do we go to get
scorpions.
To the portal?
This way.
Scampers off to the right.
To the right?
Yep.
Walk slowly. We'll stay with you.
Right. He does not walk slowly.
Follow as best I can.
Draconic angrily whispering, slow down. Does he slow down this time?
He is still, like, playing the same run animation, just slowly.
I get it.
So his feet are sliding on the ground?
Yeah.
Oh, God.
Leads you to a downwards descending set of stairs.
All right. I assume you guys are following.
Yeah, I'm not.
You finally got up. All
right.
Do you want the rear, or do you want
the front? I saw it falling pretty quick, so.
All
right.
What? Oh, the double entendre.
What's down below and asking in Draconic?
Oh, pigs. Pig Lord. Carrion King. Awful.
Cain?
King.
Carrion King?
King.
They're Carrion King.
King.
Why, have you played this adventure?
Most of you don't
understand. I don't understand what he's saying.
Some sort of king is below them. Perhaps at these pig people we've been fighting. It's probably a
Terex.
Yes, Terex.
Christ people.
Nice.
Oh, yes. Brought the pigs here. Terrible. And then, weird. Creepy crawly. Lady turns. Ooh, big one. You saw. Big like a rock. Awful. Takes the pigs. Makes them big. Awful. Never saw them before. Here at the palace. Deep down below.
Sounds like some sort of magical process.
Don't be ridiculous. Like not magic. Mm-hmm. Oh, what?
What, you say it's, you're certain it's not magical?
Oh, I mean, it's what do I know?
Indeed.
Yes.
Do you know?
I no, nothing. Sorry.
It says somehow this king is capable of turning normal Terex into the larger one we saw outside.
Why did he make them all larger then?
He doesn't have that
Thank
sort
you.
Of information. I mean, he's probably never even been in here before.
Uh-huh. That's a good role play. So it's the blind leading the blind.
Well, he does know that he's below by some means, and so far his information hasn't been terribly inaccurate. Maybe we should take that rest before we go further. I just wish I thought it was safe. What do the rest of you think?
I'm in okay shape.
I could probably go on, but I tell you what, before we step in that portal, we'll make sure we have a nice, good chat with me.
Let's do that back here, then. Right, not right up the stairs from where they might be sleeping.
Well, no, before we go into the portal. So we go down to the portal.
Oh, I see. You're saying you're fine for now. Go down in the stairs. We'll deal with whatever this is. And...
Yeah.
All right. Is everyone agreed, then? Go forward as we are?
Come on.
All right.
Yeah, if only we had a cleric.
One claws up a little bit, like...
We didn't find a cleric in one of these rooms, did we?
You found a cleric back in Slither one time, and you let him die.
Slit his throat.
No. He was helpful.
Before he was. He healed you.
Yeah. we didn't
second wind to heal. Oh, nice.
All
right. Oh, you're second winding?
Yes.
Okay.
Just heal up a bit.
We're going to head down. Lead the way, in Draconic.
I guess we need a marching order for the rest of us.
Probably.
I will go second.
No, it occurred to me we should have put some sort of like rope around this guy's neck.
Like to kill him.
No!
I think you've got plenty of tools in your arsenal.
No,
sir.
To like, you know,
a leash.
I don't know.
He's
been behaving himself.
He's the Squad of Truth's pet.
He's been behaving himself pretty
You're
well.
You're a bear.
I'm talking out of character, thank you.
Oh, thank you.
No problem. Oh, I'm sorry.
Our chat is getting accosted by spammers.
What?
Yes.
Sorry, chat.
We're a real chat channel.
I bet Shaq sent them. or Jonathan Blow.
What sort of spammers is it?
It's the IMG links with, like, the camera. So it's like...
Oh.
Learn kids or something.
I keep
Learn
getting people
kids.
Asking, like, have you read the Reddit thing on Asian masculinity?
No, let's not talk about
no,
it.
No,
that's
something, that's a spam bot.
That's a spam bot.
People someone comes in, they just post that message, there's no link, to, no nothing else.
Guess you're just supposed to Google the spam yourself.
Maybe that's it, yeah.
Huh.
That's kind of insidious.
Self-inflicted
yeah.
spam?
Yeah.
Hello?
Oh, self-inflicted.
He's okay.
Okay, you guys descend the stairs and emerge into a large chamber.
Okay. I'll go back. Alright, you're last, I'm second.
It's actually the other side, sorry.
Yeah. Oh, sorry. This way then?
Yep.
I'm second. Alright, he's first, because we made him go first and he didn't argue.
What do we see? Rocks.
Dark.
So it is dark, although it's not completely pitch black. There are actually torches set up at the entrances, of which there is one to the north here, and there is one to the west. The west seems to have a little bit more of the ruins of the palace itself, whereas the north seems to expand into more cavernous reaches, going into the hills that butt up against Yaramuke. There's a bunch of rubble immediately to the south, and then there's actually another set of stairs leading down.
Alright. Which way do we go to get to the portal?
What?
Which way do we go to get to the portal?
Pig Lord, downstairs.
We're not here for the Pig Lord. Which way do we go to get to the portal?
Oh, I just... Palace. Here, palace, look. See? Palace, big.
See the palace. You don't know where the portal is.
What? No.
Let's see. I'll put my hand on
sorry,
the door.
Sorry.
I'll put my hand on the door. We're not worried about him at the moment. Do you hear me?
Oh, the orb?
Yes. I'm thinking with my
hand. Well, I think you really have to put your hand on the orb.
I can't grab it.
Well, maybe...
Hold on, someone wants to talk to you.
Oh, yes.
That's the annoying one.
Good. Oh.
Hello. I don't suppose you know where in the palace this portal is.
Down.
Just down.
I haven't been there.
Well, you do know a lot of things.
I have orgies to attend to.
Understood. Very well. Just thought I'd ask before we massacre the entire lot of them.
Yes. Now move along. Oh my god. I'm not into that.
Very well. We head down. Guess we will continue insisting you lead the way.
So I'm guessing,
everyone give me a perception check.
Really
I actually want to smell.
Has he been in here?
Absolutely.
So why is he leading us?
20!
Do we need him anymore?
2.
He hasn't been completely useless.
Dude, but can we just let him go on his own and not worry about having another body to alert guards? He doesn't know anything.
So,
if he goes off on his own, he might alert.
Both of you hear some kind of a commotion to the north. You detect quite the rank smell.
Of, like, death?
Not of death, no. Just of bodies and fur and stink off to the west.
Is it similar to the big people who were just fighting?
It is.
Okay. North is this way?
Yes.
Okay.
Sorry, I didn't put a compass.
Nudge you a bit.
I give him a blank message so he can reply.
Bing.
There's pig people to the north. I can smell them.
Smells pig people from this
direction. Do you want to be reminded of this one's allergic reaction, apparently, to pigs?
Everyone makes mistakes. You might be forgetting. The last time, a few episodes ago, Antoria made the same mistake. that's why he's a little defensive about that one. Just for anyone who's forgotten, like, half a year ago.
Nope, I remember.
Hello. Let's go. If we're going somewhere. Below seems
how about we try
road.
Something new here? How about we listen to the one who's not ever got us into trouble? We let this one back to the surface and continue on alone.
Yeah, listen to me. Well, I mean...
Both of our sources of information agree the portal is below. We should probably get below before we attract any attention talking up here. Start heading this way, slowly.
Wow. That's Marcus.
Oh, you got buff, man. You got buff.
I'm insisting the lizard guy come with me.
I'll follow.
Are you guys just marching over, or are you doing something different?
Stealthily, I suppose.
Nope, bear's gonna saunter over.
I'm just walking.
Yeah, bear's sauntering
over. I'll be stealthy.
That seems like there's a
plan. This is a unified effort.
12?
Natural 20. I'm stealthy enough for everybody. Yeah.
You're like putting
bang his gauntlets together.
You're like putting carpet underneath.
I appreciate that the failure music came up yet again.
Yeah.
As the stealth check was called for. What did you get?
12.
12. You guys are actually not all that noisy.
Yeah, 22 here, but.
Oh, yeah.
Even if I'm not trying.
I mean, there's no one in the room.
Okay.
Barrett can hear you.
Cool.
I can smell you, too.
Yeah.
I guess head down the stairs.
You guys make it to the stairs unaccosted.
Lizard in front, we go.
You know, if we find any pigmen, we should drop a bag and then make a noise and have them inspect the bag.
Oh, the bag's here.
We could try it, I suppose.
It might be fun, and if not, we know how to handle them.
We can leave the bag on.
Actually, I might have an idea on that front. I actually will very carefully unwrap the bag of holding.
Let me get
permanent
it.
Holding.
Hold,
yeah. I think Marvin's character just really wants to see more people get eaten by the bag.
So funny thing, you can't activate a magic item with Mage Hand, but you can just move one.
Sure.
If you're not activating it.
Yeah.
So I will cast Mage Hand, put the bag on the ground, and have it begin going downstairs.
Okay.
I can direct it up to 30 feet, so...
Okay, so you just start moving it.
Yeah, I'm letting it lead us down the stairs 30 feet in front of us.
Okay. It seems to drop down relatively unaccosted.
Okay. Go down behind it. I'm maintaining and recasting as necessary Mage Hand. so that it can stay ahead of us.
I love that this is our
party.
Like, it's like our, you got a little mine layer in front of us. The first guy is going to get eaten or whatever.
Wow.
And then you guys descend down the stairs yourselves?
20 minutes later we do.
With a bag 30. No, it's not that slow. Magians? Not that slow for moving objects. Remember, it can move 30 feet a turn.
That actually should rotate that way.
Oh, wait.
So just that those stairs are facing Herbie.
Oh, okay.
There we go.
There we go. Alright.
Oh, yeah, I mean.
We did it.
So you guys descend to a relatively more intact chamber.
I guess we're all off the stairs now at this point?
Yes. Although actually they emerge on the other side, close to the wall.
There's a bag.
The bag is like here.
Excellent. So like I was saying, this room is actually pretty well preserved. This room, more than anywhere that you've seen before, seems to retain a little bit of the regal nature that you'd expect from a sorceress queen's palace. There's a majestic colonnade breaking off a badly, badly rank chamber to the north. It appears to be maybe of just as much size and maybe as much splendor. There's some awful, awful smell coming from that way.
Nature check to identify the smell?
Sure.
That's probably not going well with a natural one.
You appear to be in a ruin of some kind.
I like the idea that you have such a delicate palate that you can differentiate.
Well,
between
it's
like,
a really strong.
Oh, this was a dead raccoon.
Well, no, I wasn't going for anything. I was just basically, is it a familiar smell? I mean, if it's that strong, you might be able to recognize generally something.
Does a 15 tell anything?
It smells simply like rotting carrion. There's also a double set of doors to the west. Your lizardman friend looks terribly nervous.
Antoria, time to cut him loose. He can't do any more good here. And in the worst case, he's going to, you know, get in our way.
Alright, Antoria actually turns to the lizardman. Would you like to leave now?
He's actually all but clutching your leg. I'm not gonna do that.
Yeah.
Lobos, please do that.
Please
no, we're good. We're good. We're good. And Troy turns back to Marvin and says he doesn't want to leave. I'm not willing to force you.
I'm not gonna be responsible for
anything.
Catching him in the crossfire.
As long as you don't aim directly at him again, I'll be alright with it.
Again,
listen, I
don't know how unified this party is.
Party's a strong word.
We prefer coalition.
squad.
Squad. Yeah, we
mutual,
prefer squad.
Mutual semi non-aggression pact. mutual limited aggression.
I'll only fireball you every
like
other
iron
session.
Curtain right here.
Is it only around you?
Yeah, pretty much. All right.
The guy that fireballs us like every other session.
He is the most evil out of everyone.
Something we haven't pointed out yet, his character is all about doing the most potential damage he can do within a turn. And that includes...
So regardless of...
Yeah.
Oh, you guys remember their inspiration mechanic?
Yeah,
I completely forget about it every single turn.
Yeah.
Well, I mean...
Sorry, guys.
Now that, you know, Fireball, you can be a little more... It's funny that you say... I say this, but Fireball, you can be more precise on not hitting your teammates.
You can.
Like,
yeah.
Earlier abilities are just kind of like, well, it's so small of a range, I have to...
Yeah.
I think they were very specific about that with Fireball because it's such a classic spell.
Yeah.
Because
yeah.
You can definitely tell which spells they've done that with and which they haven't.
Yeah.
Yeah, Circle of Death. It's everything in a 100-foot radius. It's like, where can I aim this?
Yeah.
At least like a 60-foot range, too. So there's no way to avoid having
well,
you in the center.
When you were a lich, you could aim it everywhere.
Yeah. Remember when Notoria was a lich?
I wasn't actually resistant or immune to necrotic. I was resistant to cold, but
I'm
not
sure it'd speed up the process.
Yeah, you definitely would do that. Anyway. Yeah. All right. Well, so there's doors here. Where's the other doors at? Are they not on the map? Like over here?
I don't think these are doors.
I think
what
it's
is that?
No.
It's like a bunch of columns.
Symbol
like
thing there.
That's a
bag.
The bag.
Oh, that's the bag.
Do you want to open it up and take a look inside?
All right. Let's see. Alright, we'll continue this way with the bag staying 30 feet in front. Braver
than the rest of the party.
See, that's the party pet.
Yeah.
A bag that eats a man.
Yeah. Seems like an accurate
I like
pet
the idea of having like a giving you like a halberd, and at the end of the halberd we just put a bag in there.
I just like poke at people and they're like, what the
Glad you made a prop for the bag.
Actually, that was sent to me by Walnuts on YouTube when I got my wonderful this.
Wonderful this.
Audio interface.
That's it.
What is it called?
Preamp,
thank you.
One question, is this an accurate representation of the bag, including these little strap things?
Yes. The only thing that's inaccurate about that is it doesn't have the sharp pointy teeth.
Yes.
Well, it's also... never mind.
No. Alright, well...
We actually don't know...
See, this is not inside the bag.
Yeah, okay. I'm sure I was kind of looking around. I don't see anyone who's going to fall through this bag until we open the door, and at that point, it's probably going to be pointless.
Well, can we open the door, and there's a bag there. Just like move off to the side, open the door.
I do have an idea that might make this a little more effective, although it's not without risk. I'll actually slide the bag back over here, and then very carefully, not touching anything near the inside.
Uh-huh.
Let's see. What do I have that would be shiny?
Well, this bag is nothing but trouble for our group.
I will use a piece of string or twine, which I'm sure I have somewhere. I have a lot of adventuring.
You probably got some of your hairy, filthy hobo.
You probably cut off a piece
probably.
Of
probably. Anyway, yeah.
You goddamn vagrant.
I will contrive to attach a gold piece by a string to one of these. So that
a gold piece or a gold bit?
Gold bit.
Okay.
Probably have some actual gold pieces.
I know, that's why I asked.
I'd like to do an actual gold piece.
What? Yeah. That's nuts.
Anyway, so an actual gold piece attached.
Gold piece.
I'm using it to lure them into the bag. Never mind. Just
leave
it there.
Eaten by the bag.
No. That would be terrible. All right.
Goodbye.
So now can I assume I've successfully attached it to one of these?
Sure.
All right, cool.
Oh, putting it off one stock into the Carrion King caring about a gold piece.
Well,
sometimes it's more about the journey.
Yeah, very much. All right,
some days love will find you.
The door.
I like to imagine we open the door and there's a dragon there, and the dragon just
and then it starts eating it from the inside.
Yeah.
Oh god.
Let me tell you, the squad of truth is all about the journey. All
right. Well, the doors. What are they like?
Stone.
Okay. Probably
heavy.
Probably can't pull these open magically. I'll look for traps.
Is there space under the door to slide a bag?
No.
Right. I will look for
deliberately to ward off interlopers.
I will look
they
for
thought
not
of everything.
Bag sized.
I'll look for traps on the door.
Sure.
There's a bag. This door.
15 with investigation.
You don't find any traps.
We're just playing D&D.
Doesn't seem traps.
Dungeons and bags.
All you.
All right. Do the doors look?
They do.
And I'm still keeping Mei-Chan going so that I can continue to manipulate the bag.
Okie doke.
Does it also have handles?
It does.
Alright.
Looks like a pull door.
Okay.
Okay.
I'm gonna move up and like pull the door such that I'm opening it and being behind the door as I
And I'll begin sliding the bag in immediately.
This is a team effort.
Whoa, is that a gold piece?
Anything reacting inside the chamber?
Nothing immediately.
Okay, I'll push it a little further to the max of my range.
It seems to hit a wall.
And I'll get in front so I can see anything in there.
There's just a sort of disappointed looking bag sitting on the floor.
There's no wall?
There's a gold piece attached to it. There is bag that's...
Let's go get that.
there is a wall that it's butted up against, yes.
Alright, I guess we need a map.
Yeah...
I guess.
I have a lot of those.
This is probably really confusing for anyone who doesn't know what the bag actually does.
All the better.
Let's just hope they don't counter bag.
Oh, what if they have an anti-bag spell?
It does, it explodes, consuming everything in like a mile radius. It actually is a thing that happens if you pierce a bag of holding.
Yeah.
Yeah. Really?
Yeah.
This one, if I remember correctly, has some fun things too. My identify spell didn't pick them up, so I'm kind of pretending I don't know about them.
Ah.
for whatever reason, identify didn't pick them up, so...
What is, I mean, how can you pierce a bag of holding?
You can just stab it.
Really?
Yeah.
I thought you couldn't really go through magical items that way.
Depends on the item.
Yeah. Some generally you can't, but some might specifically
I think there's like
say,
a threshold, a certain amount of right. damage or something it has to take. But
I like that in attack too. It's like a number of ridiculous, like if they get disenchanted or something, they just explode.
Yeah.
All right. Well.
So does that like consume the entire universe?
Yeah. It's actually it's like
it
a.
Depends on
it's
the
actually
universe.
What happened to
it's
Dark
a,
Sun.
It's a radius around it. It's like 20 foot or some big,
oh.
some big like
peak around.
It's like a fireball.
Yeah.
Okay, so it's not.
It's just for the dude stuff. Who's carrying it. It's
right.
a big problem.
Yeah. Okay.
I assume Lizard Guy is staying real close
or
to
party
me, unless otherwise specified.
Literally in your shadow.
Okay. My shadow.
Literally, he like melded into it.
Gross.
The secret things he's not telling us.
So, there appears to be a hallway down to your left that opens up into a chamber on your right,
mm-hmm.
with more doors on the left.
Okay.
Not
what
more
door. Is
it? No, more door is not on the left.
Especially not multiple more doors.
No, just the one.
Okay. And what's this little gap here? Another hallway or something?
No, that's opening into. Wait, what?
There's a gap here.
Yeah.
Is this supposed to go on top of that? Like this?
Yeah, let's go
okay.
with that.
All right.
Let me double check this thing that I might have based the map on. Oh no! You know what? That opens up into a different, separate room.
Okay, so where it was.
Right where it was.
Okay.
So there's a big chamber off on the right. There's a smaller chamber right there.
Gotcha.
And there's more stuff, more door.
There we go.
More door.
That makes sense. Right.
Yeah.
Inching the bag into that intersection. Any reaction from noises or anything?
No.
Okay. I will move it a little further this way and then peek around the corner.
Okay. That opens up.
I'm about to just, like, as a bear, grab the bag and throw it behind
you
us.
You don't
want to
grab this bag. You're not that. You're not strong enough, man. Not to safely make that check.
Or dexterous enough to grab it by the parts of your body.
Might be strong enough. I don't know.
I think it was a DC 20. You want to bet your character on DC 20? The only reason we didn't lose anyone was you have double advantage dude over here.
This opens up into a large hallway with a spiral stairway leading up and a couple of double doors. Double doors, not Dumbledores. As much as I would love that.
A couple of Dumbledores up there.
That doesn't seem to be the right way. I'll move the bag this way
and
have it.
And Tori, can you use your fancy... see-through wall stuff to find out maybe where this portal is.
See-through walls?
Yeah, the magic. Find the magic.
It doesn't go through walls, though.
It doesn't?
No. What? It's also very short range.
What kind of a magic
they
bag
change.
Doesn't go through doors?
They changed that from...
Yeah, it's pretty short range.
That sucks.
It's short range and it's.
I'm so glad because players all the time like, where's the
yeah,
magic?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, let's go
that,
there.
Yeah, that's why.
Oh,
why
detect
it,
magic.
Yeah,
yeah,
that's why
they
were
talking about.
Out of it,
yeah,
sure.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
I think it's like a 30-foot range too, or something like that. I'd have to look.
We had a party in Eberron for 3.5 with a paladin that was good. Detect evil whenever he encountered anyone or anything.
Yeah.
And just spotlight.
That's
like,
probably all. That's probably also why it's not a cantrip or a free spell, but. Alright, is everyone following me? You guys are like still back here.
Yeah, we're sneaking behind.
Yeah. Alright, they're sneaking behind. Alright.
I'm watching the bag.
The bag is
you watching the bag
around
the
corner of this bigger opening.
Okay.
Any reaction?
It bursts into flame.
Oh no!
Oh!
Well, go stomp it out.
And do you pull it back or.
What shit is that in Toria?
It seems to have done its job.
Finding a trap.
Apparently. I will pull it back 5.
Okay. Still on fire.
I mean, that could just...
Does it look like it's like actually burning, or is it magic item-y enough where it probably will survive?
It looks like it's burning magically, but not as intensely as it perhaps might if it weren't a magical bag.
Alright, I will... carefully using one of the blankets I usually kept it in, try to put it out.
Oh, your hobo.
Yeah, but I am
wraps.
But I am avoiding the edge of it. If that part's burning, that's just tough luck for the bag. I'll put out the 85% of it I can safely reach without coming near the edge of it.
Alright, you managed to stamp it out.
I can't wait for you to die at this scene.
Yeah. You're, like, trying to put it out in the bag, just
like, we're gonna, like, roll dex. Oh.
No, there's very specific rules we've identified for how it works. As long as I don't touch the edge, I should be okay.
Yep.
Does it put out
as long as he just tickles the frills, he's fine.
We good? On the fire part?
Thank you.
But you'd still eat me if I touched you, wouldn't
no.
you?
No!
Dead of honor!
Shimron?
Sorry.
Alright. That was not nearly a Batman enough voice for Shimron.
Okay, so I observed it catch fire. Did I observe a trap going off or something?
Got a perception check.
Yeah, did I see what caused that? Natural 20.
Oh, wow.
No, you did not, as a matter of fact. In fact, it looks like maybe a spell was cast.
Hmm. I think that was a spell, not a trap. Alright.
Don't look at me.
Send the bag back in.
Takes in the bag.
Seriously, don't look at me.
I will send the bag in very rapidly, moving it all the way over here in one action this time.
Thanks. Where is it going?
I moved it all the way. I moved it as far as Mage Hand could.
Okay. Give me an Arcana check.
Okay. 12.
You can feel a conflicting force wrest hold of the bag and yank it into the room.
We've got trouble. Come on.
I need that bag.
Alright. Toria's.
Never separate a hobo from his fucking bag.
Alright.
We lost her most important party right. member.
Toria's going in.
Following in.
And Toria cares more about the bag than the rest.
Sorry
of the
that it's
members.
Not super more decorated, but. It actually opens up into rotate a little bit more.
Oh, sorry.
Like this?
Like, yeah. Nope. That, yeah! This is actually a remarkably well-preserved library of some kind.
Oh.
There are shelves and shelves of books.
I thought those didn't exist in this world.
No, they don't. Except in Sorcerer's Queen's palaces.
I'm kidding.
Which you happen to be inside of. Did you bring your library card? Paulo, did you bring your library card?
You know,
I'm a bear, so no.
System.
What a good talk.
Is Conan the librarian here?
The bag is,
I think these books are overdue.
Yeah!
The bag is squirming at the feet of a black-robed figure who stands in the center of the library, idly thumbing through one of the tomes. Her hood is pushed back to reveal long, dark hair and sort of a dark visage, I guess you'd call it. She has dark bags under her eyes, and she has very sort of sharp, austere kind of features that belie a rough life. But at the same time, she seems calm, collected, given the fact that there's some sort of a squirming artifact at her feet. She turns sort of generally in your direction, but without looking up at you, and says, "Really, I would have thought you would have learned not to interfere."
Rahad usually had much the same sort of things to say when we met with him.
Rahad liked to prance around, parade his own power.
That is true.
And much to his demise.
We tried speaking with him reasonably. We suspected we may not have even had any real difference of opinion. But
every storm disappears once it is spent, but stone, rock, ore persists.
But not necessarily
timelessly,
on the same plane of existence.
Forever.
She's not even listening to you. Do you know where there's a portal around here?
It's the only reason we're here.
Yeah, we'll be on our way. You can direct us there.
I do, and I will not.
I would like to
use... Its energies are ours to wield.
We're not interested in the energies. We were asked to see what's on the other side.
To know it is to behold it, and to behold it is to use it.
Interesting.
I would like to use Intimidate here.
On play.
To say...
She seems pretty easily spooked.
She's just a girl. Come on.
I would like to say, we mean you no harm. We must not fight and destroy all these beautiful
this
books here.
This is an Intimidate
here.
Check.
Yeah.
Whoa, I don't want any trouble.
Persuasion and Intimidate. Persuasion or Intimidate?
I just said we're gonna destroy all the books if she doesn't.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Victoria's looking at you very oddly as soon as you mention destroying books.
These all look like really good reads. I'm sure we.
Here, put this over your head.
We're
no, it should be like that red anime angry symbol. You did say destroy books.
Oh, you're bleeding from your nose.
Yeah.
That's a different symbol.
We're happy to lead you to your books if you'll kindly direct us to this portal. And I'm using Intimidate here with an 11.
You do manage at least to get her to look up from her reading.
Let's have a drink at the
You're
same
in.
Same
Mission accomplished.
You have interfered in the Far Herald's affairs once, but no more. I am Taja, Herald of Storm, and I will not allow you to stick your noses where they do not belong. Even as she speaks, a towering form bursts forth from the floor, made from the stuff of the earth itself.
I beg you.
I have to go to the bathroom.
Bye.
Okay.
Give me a bathroom check.
No, I have to go to the bathroom.
Oh,
excuse
me.
Your
manage,
please.
I'll give you my manage.
Sure.
16. Marvin leaves briefly.
Marvin will be right back after these.
Her intimidate check worked then, I'm guessing.
This bathroom break brought to you by Nos.
Oh, literally.
No, quite literally.
Thanks, everyone.
Too.
Okay, well, there's...
Two.
You can use my restroom
right?
If you like.
Okay.
Yeah, go for it.
I'll go to the restroom. Mark,
it's probably more gross
restroom
than the
restroom
guest
restroom
one, but
he's
whatever.
Towards the bag.
Was she casting a spell when to summon that guy?
She actually was not.
Okay. I didn't think she was, and they normally haven't had to. Just checking.
They have special stuff.
Yeah.
That doesn't work with counterspell.
Yeah. Where is that one thing?
Yeah, I don't have Banish up, unfortunately. I'm going to do that once in a while.
Yeah.
At the moment. I'd have it back if we'd done a short rest, but I don't think that was a good idea. Anyway, we were...
Parlo!
You're in the middle of an infiltration.
Yeah.
You can't say, it looks like an hour nap right here in the middle of the enemy base. You just got inside the door.
I've heard of Stranger.
Yeah. We actually tried that the first time we were infiltrating an enemy base and...
Oh, yeah!
That was pretty much how we got captured, so I wasn't keen on repeating it.
Was that in
that
Slither?
That was Slither, yeah.
Okay.
We got to the bottom floor, got the crap to get out of us, tried resting for an hour, about 20 minutes into it, came home, and things went mad.
I won the race.
Good job.
I'd like to thank Shaq. He was in my mind the whole time.
What?
This runs really directly contrary to my antagonistic persona.
Shaq guided me to victory. That's where I was going with that.
Barrett, why don't you give me an initiative roll?
Can do. 4.
4?
Yes.
Yeah.
Marcus.
8.
Victoria.
22.
Try hard. And then...
I got this. Fuck.
Victoria, you're up first. Marvin, you're on deck.
Alright.
Well, I see him on the map. Where's she?
As a matter of fact, she seems to have disappeared.
No spell for that either, huh?
There was actually a spell for that if you'd like to try and do something about it.
I actually think I would like to try and do something about that.
Very well.
I will attempt a counterspell. Was her spell third level or lower?
It was not.
Okay, I have to make a check.
Good, now you can fight two really strong opponents.
Yeah. This doesn't, like inter- like this doesn't interrupt my narrative at all. but that's fine.
Never mind, she's good. And Toria's shield flares up brighter than before, but that's about the only thing that seems to happen for this spell.
Says your lizardman friend. Anything else?
Well, that was a reaction.
That was a reaction, so now you get your turn.
Now I get my turn.
What a special boy.
Go ahead and move into the room.
Head and over.
Back at it.
Here. And launch a firebolt at the earth elemental thing.
Whoa, 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 whoa.
I'm flying earth.
No, it does 12 hit.
12 does not hit.
Yeah, I didn't think so.
Probably has low EC.
It's probably a good natural armor, but anyway.
Anything else?
That's me. Done.
Marvant. Marcus, you're next.
How does this thing look identical to that other thing we banished?
As a matter of fact, it does not. This thing seems a little bit more composed, whereas the other thing looked a little bit more boulder-like.
While I'm thinking about it really quick, this is a library, so we'll go ahead and say there's shelves.
You can change where you move.
Yeah, it's probably not worth drawing all those out.
Yeah, I would.
It's gonna knock them over.
Yeah, I probably would actually just stay back then.
All right.
That much crowded and stuff.
So I basically can't see in the room. Can I? I guess I could.
You see some confusing sandwiches with words inside.
Well, this isn't actually here, by the way. I get, or is he sharing a space with that Antoria at this point? The lizard.
He is small. He's just wrapped on you.
He gets his own square.
Okay. Yeah.
He's a person.
Sorry, I'm
his compelling backstory.
We haven't treated him like a person yet, but yes.
Hey, you don't treat each other like people.
Hey, one of us has treated him somewhat like a person.
Can I use
they didn't throw them into the bag of devouring, yes.
A lot further. I would like to use, I don't know if this is Arcana or Insight, but I want to determine if rocks would be like immune or resistant to bludgeoning damage.
That's going to be actually Arcana or Nature, your call. Insight is more like, are you lying to me?
Okay.
I think they're both ants.
Okay, yeah,
they're
both ants.
Going to be whatever that.
Nine?
Nine what?
Arcana.
You're not sure.
Can I have a second opinion?
Thanks a lot.
it's not bend luckable, if that helps.
Yeah. Okay, that's fine.
Bend luckable.
So a 20-foot radius sphere. Is this 20 feet radius?
Yeah, it's
fireball.
Oh, boy. Oh my god. $5.
It's the whole room. It's basically the whole room.
Yep.
Including invisible creatures.
And the bag.
And the most expensive
and
things
I've
ever encountered in this entire world. I've encountered and destroyed books before, so it's...
I'll step over here.
Actually, that's usually their natural reaction to books.
No.
Learning!
I stand on top of me or whatever. And I'll say, you're not the only one with elemental powers, which...
Oh my.
Yes.
And then a...
oh, that's not a pun.
That was
not
fun.
A sphere appears in the middle of the room. Which is about the same size as a fireball, but it's not
a
fireball.
Oh my god. What is it?
It is a storm sphere!
That's a huge sphere.
It's really awesome.
Sounds awesome.
Like, imagine a really strong hurricane with lightning doing its thing,
wind doing its thing.
So basically.
Could you put it under that guy, I guess? Does it persist?
Mm-hmm.
Permanent!
Like forever?
No, for a minute.
A minute. Forever?
Forever?
Alright, so, first off.
That was by a black person.
Save versus strength, or take 2d6 bludgeoning damage.
Oh, no problem.
So.
What's my. Oh my god, never
16.
Mind.
So, you take 10 points of bludgeoning damage.
Bludgeoned.
And along with any sort of invisible creatures in the room.
Okay. So all the books.
If there were any. So go ahead and roll for invisible.
I don't think she used invisibility. That's a low-level spell. Counter
she used teleportation.
Yeah, counter would have knocked out invisibility.
Damn. That sucks.
You just got told.
Yeah.
Goodbye.
Alright, in addition to
book,
that,
for which I'm
I would like to use my Tides of Chaos. Well,
Listen, okay, ten at a turn.
I can use my Tides of Chaos to do a ranged spell attack here. So as a bonus action, I basically can shoot lightning at something.
Okay.
And if they're within 30 feet of the sphere, which he clearly is, he has disadvantage.
Okay.
Oh, sorry. Disadvantage on wisdom, perception, and shit. No one cares about that. So, I'm gonna use my Tides of Chaos to get advantage on this. And a crit.
Oh!
Not bad.
So, this looks...
One of my crits there.
Yeah, right.
So ones. That's,
20.
Yeah, that's
alright, so 27 points of lightning damage.
Not bad.
As a bolt comes from the very middle and strikes the very middle. So it's not very impressive, but just...
In, out.
Yeah. And then, do you want me to recharge my Tides of Chaos for...
Well, God, do I.
Okay.
Please cast Fireball. Oh, wait, on yourself? Never mind.
Which spell was that again?
Storm Sphere.
Okay, got it.
It's from the extra.
Sorry.
And I don't get a save for that? It's just an attack roll each time?
Yeah, it's attack roll.
Okay.
And sorry, it's the first time using that, so I was a little shaky.
No, don't worry about it.
You're stuff. That's a damn shaky on stuff I use all the time.
Yeah, and just
Phil's here.
Magic Missile is a fifth level spell!
Whoa!
That's a lot of missiles.
That is. So, it's basically five missiles? Is that right?
You still have to make an attack roll, right?
Nope.
Just magic missile. Hit
that's right,
so,
magic missile.
I know that from
the
game.
It was wild magic.
Wait, no, this is a lot.
Get
oh my
it.
God, yeah. This is three darts. A level five
seven,
magic missile.
Seven darts.
Seven darts.
One D4.
Yeah. I got plenty of them, actually.
Oh.
Yeah.
One, two, three, four, five, six. Caltrops outside his yard with home defense. Just gathers them up before D&D.
Damn Caltrops.
2, 3, 6, 7.
For some reason, I thought you were saying the word
10,
cactuar.
13, 17.
Do you remember in Final Fantasy 12 that subquest that's just like, look at those cactuars that keep invading our land? And then the camera cuts away, and it's just those cactuars just like dancing. And the NPC is like literally like, look at those fucking dancing cactuars! He doesn't say fucking because it's a Final Fantasy game. And then it cuts back, and he's like, ugh! You're always up there dancing. It drives me crazy.
24 points.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah, that was.
Who do you think you are, Marcus?
Yeah,
right? Is this
and I will, and then I'll shout out. The storm sphere is benign to friends.
No one knows what that word means.
Yeah.
Marcus is
a bear.
Friends.
What was it? Friends.
Benign to people I like.
No one enters this game.
Yeah.
Everyone looks at each other uncertainly.
Marcus, it's your turn.
Get in there, buddy.
Marcus doesn't give shit anyways. 5, 10, 15.
Oh,
it's actually
wait.
A trait.
You shocked me.
Yeah, you died.
I actually lied. Fuck.
Of course you did.
I forgot the first part.
What's the first part?
Well, when he ends his turn, then.
I swing at this beast. 22 hit.
That hits.
Alright.
So did he seriously just yell at them to go in there and then you're gonna beat the shit out of them?
It's
friendly
to you! Yeah, the thing is, Marvin's
friendly to you!
14 damage.
Marvin's a little like, he shoots from the hip.
Noticing that.
Attack number two.
Oh, so
benign to friends.
This is all
I
new.
Think.
This is all new to him. So.
16 damage.
Benign is code
I'm
word for damaging.
Is this thing
I didn't
brain,
know the word.
Can I brain punch this thing?
You can try.
You
I think
you
have to reach out.
Yeah, you would have to use it.
You don't have the kind of cognizance to be able to like detect its mind just
right.
Yet.
Okay. I'm not gonna bring much.
Okay.
I am done.
Okay.
So when you end your turn there, you have to do a strength save of 16. It should be easy for you, or you take 7 points
should
damage.
Should be.
But it's not.
7 points of bludgeoning damage.
What was the save? Right. DC?
DC 16.
This is just
strength.
Books
I
getting
a two and a four.
Buffeted against him by hurricane force winds.
Anywhere,
you're getting destroyed by knowledge.
That's the worst.
Not that it matters.
The one thing Marcus wasn't prepared for. Oh, I just love that you were... Get in there, guys!
Why has the lizard been in there? He would not do that.
Marvin forcibly
moved him. I put him on top of me. He's like, we're in the same square. Right.
There's a hurricane in there. I don't want to go in. I don't want to go in.
Yeah, not benign to friends.
All right, Marcus!
What?
Do you remember in the forest on the way to Moonlight Butterfly how the big stone guards can just go like shh and try and slow you?
Yes.
This guy does that.
Oh.
It's actually it's really handy.
Walk of peace.
Yes. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Give me a wisdom saving throw.
Eleven.
Okay. Yes.
Actually, creatures that have if it's wisdom perception, that they have disadvantage. Okay.
You would have disadvantage?
Yeah, everyone in the sphere, within 30 feet of that sphere.
We already failed.
Okay, well.
Is it on saving throws too?
It's just wisdom perception.
Yeah, it probably doesn't mean saving throws at all.
It's probably just seeing in the middle of the hurricane.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay, so you can't use reactions. Your speed is halved. And you can't make more than one attack per turn.
Oh, that's brutal.
Also, you can take an action or a bonus action on your turn, but not both.
Okay.
This lasts for a minute, but you can save at the end of each of your turns to try and get rid of it.
Okay, that sounds bad.
Okay.
And you're being buffeted by dicks.
There's books everywhere. Now it's going to try and punch you with its stone fist.
Benign storm spirit is continuing to fumble. That's not the
oh my fucking god.
What?
Nothing. He's got absolutely nothing.
He whiffs.
This guy is in the middle of a hurricane.
He is in the middle. Well, if he was in the exact middle of a hurricane, he should have no problems.
Yeah, no, it's not a hurricane. It's a benign.
Barrett, it's your turn.
More dangerous than our
hurricane. Intoria, you're on deck.
Alright.
Barrett.
Run in there.
Yeah.
Get going, buddy.
Baby, get in there. You got Baron points anyway. It's not yours.
Fine.
Druids love nature.
He ended his turn.
What?
He did end his turn.
There.
Yes.
Benign storm sphere.
11 points of damage if he fails a 16 strength.
Is that a magical effect?
It's more spell. I hope so.
It's bludgeoning damage. But yeah, it's from a magical.
Yeah.
All right.
Hello.
Oh,
no. It's okay.
Hello.
I forgive you.
Does he take half? If
it's, I save? He resists all of it if he saves.
Books.
All right. I was gonna say that earlier. His card catalog of attacks wasn't all that maxed.
Dewey Decimal System. Bear, what are you doing?
He charges in. He's swinging.
Ryan, do you want me to move that printer from behind you?
Alright, I'm gonna make the black die the bite this time.
No.
Doesn't okay.
Doesn't matter.
Damn,
I don't think he knew it was there until you
said it. No, I knew it was there. Unless you're worried about
so
me, like, knocking
know.
It over.
15.
I wasn't worried about you hitting your head, that's all.
Does a 15 hit?
No!
Okay, then I have missed both my attacks, and then I'm gonna get buffeted by a storm for no good goddamn reason.
7 points?
It's like it's my birthday.
well, I get a save, right?
16 strength.
Strength. I'm good at that. I got it. Okay, no doubt. I got 21.
This is the worst birthday ever.
My thick fur bounces it off. Or wait, the other way around. It bounces off my thick
Antoria, please take your turn.
I will take my turn.
Get in there, please.
Yeah. I'm not going in, but I will take my turn.
Throw the bag in the room.
It's in the room.
Oh no!
It's in the middle of the room.
Should we be rolling
it
around?
Oh my god, it's flying
around.
No!
Well,
actually,
that's a really good point.
That's terrifying.
Everything is fine for now.
Here's like the idea of this just consuming everything.
Yeah.
It's just like flying and there's a book like right behind it.
If my character was to die, I would be okay with that.
And Toria will launch a firebolt at the giant elemental.
Sure.
a 20 hit.
It does.
Alright. Magical fire damage is coming its way.
Marvin, you're up next.
Okay. We'll do 18 fire.
18.
Okay, and that is my turn after reminding in Draconic my lizard friend not to go in the room. I don't think I had to worry about that.
I think that was necessary.
Yeah.
Marvin, you're up. Marcus, you're next.
All right, bonus action. A bolt of lightning goes on a...
Sweet.
Yeah.
On Marcus.
On the that dude. Oh, I have to do a range. My bad. I will use Tides of Chaos. Actually, I can't use that here. That's just. Yeah,
there's a lot of words.
Turn it on a second. I think it's just any time I use a spell attack.
Yeah, you can do it. If it's a spell attack, you can definitely do it.
So let me get. 16.
16 does not hit.
So I miss the lightning bolt. It strikes near Marcus's feet.
Hey!
Take that, Marcus.
I mean,
hey!
I mean, oh,
thank
very
you.
Good.
Very
good.
It
hits
the bag.
It's the bag.
Anything else?
I will use a cloud of daggers.
Do you have one?
Wait a minute, though. This is concentrate, I'm pretty sure.
Oh, fuck. Yes, it is.
Yeah.
I can't use that. That's not what I meant to say. I meant to say, I will use...
Yes.
Shattered?
I was thinking about that one.
I thought someone didn't take Shatter.
I relearned it.
Oh.
Yeah.
They can do that.
Why did you encounter an elemental?
Yeah, there was a situation.
Well, we encountered crystal guys, we encountered skeleton guys, we encountered an elemental.
I basically unlearned witch bolts.
Oh, so time to start throwing ghosts at you guys again.
Yeah, so that's where we're getting to.
Good,
yeah.
Good. All right,
well, I think I actually will use Shatter here. So a second level spell. Okay. And, so he has disadvantage on the saving throw.
This is a magical effect.
Yeah.
Yes.
Alright, good.
What's the range? Who does it hit?
It's gonna hit, it's just 10 foot radius, so...
It's easy to...
There.
Okay.
Yeah.
Just checking.
8. So, 11 points of damage, halved if he can beat a 16 con.
Roll a 1.
Oh, that doesn't.
And he has advantage on magical saves, so it canceled the disadvantage,
okay.
And I rolled a 1 anyway.
So he should take double damage.
Describe for me your killing blow.
Oh, what? Serious?
Yeah.
That was quick.
Marvin, no, it wasn't. You guys
Marvin,
did 100 points of damage.
Marvin,
super fucking quickly.
Marvin, Marvin.
I did 18.
Casts a shatter, ready to follow up with something, and looks strangely disappointed as he says, is that all we had? That's all? Okay.
Yes, now stop the hurricane!
Do you want me to roll for wild magic on that one?
Yes, of course.
All I heard from that was, DM, come at me, bro.
Well, no, it sucks. I wasted a level.
No, I could have easily lied and said he had more hit points. I mean, come on.
You should have done that.
No, I'm just saying what he said was that.
Oh.
I have nine.
Oh, DM, come at me.
I have nine lightning
yeah.
bolts still available. So.
Well, maybe I'll throw some more enemies at you.
They have to come within a minute, though.
Well, you're in the middle of the fucking dungeon.
Start running through stuff.
Yeah, pull them. Pull them off.
Yeah. Kite them back to
the... We need a mob train stat.
They need entangling roots or whatever.
Yeah.
Like
he's
falling.
So he's gone?
Yep.
Alright.
He exploded.
Wait, did you roll wild magic?
No, I didn't make it. It was one of the
d20s. Oh, one of those.
Yeah.
Okay.
Pass it on.
Okay.
Where am I putting this?
Give it to Brennan.
Oh, thank you.
Are we stopping the whirlwind that includes a bag of...
Oh, yeah, I stopped my concentration.
Okay.
And
the bag, I assume, drops to the ground somewhere.
Well, Antonio, were you impressed?
A little more elaborate than my method of banishing them, but it did work.
Yes.
I admit.
Just throw it there.
Yes. The, I don't know if you knew, but that magic missile wasn't part of the spell. I don't know what that came from.
I'm confused about one thing, though. I could have swore I heard you say it was safe for our friends, but I'm pretty sure I saw
Yeah, I actually, I remember when I was do sorcerers have spell books? Or
well,
they
don't.
They
just, it's all instinctive.
It's all,
okay. They just do it.
I had thought it was safe, but then I remembered that it actually wasn't.
That's the best excuse.
Marvin, please take a point of inspiration if you don't have one yet.
I don't.
All right, well, you get one.
Antoria starts to say something, then he just kind of stops and says, nods and says, yeah, I believe
you. Hey, it did its job, didn't it?
As I said. I suppose the library is completely destroyed.
Oh my god.
But
that bag ate everything.
I will take.
Never have I been saved the agony of having to roll up what scrolls you guys find.
Well, you might not be saved it yet, because if you've got 10 minutes, I'm going to cast Detect Magic.
Also, I'll have you know that this is the first thing we haven't burnt down. That was.
Oh, we haven't left the room yet.
We did throw a fireball first, you remember. That was your first.
No, the fireball was just the shape of the.
It's a convenient 20-foot radius.
I haven't yet been asked to create a
storm
sphere miniature, so.
The fog cloud one would work.
It would have, yeah. I'm sure it's. I mean, it's not nearly as.
Yeah, oh, that's right. Better. I forgot about that.
Yeah, that would have been fine. But anyway.
Yeah, yeah.
So
I want one that has a graphic.
Take
Marcus
10 minutes,
being
assuming
hit.
Nothing. Assuming nothing interrupts us for 10 minutes. Detect magic-y stuff.
Okay. Everyone give me a perception check.
Smell base?
21.
15.
Sight only or smells?
No, smells fine.
Okay. 24.
Anything worth mentioning? Okay. A couple of minutes in, there's quite a bit of tromping in your general direction. Seems as though perhaps you may have caused some commotion.
I don't think we have time to finish this. Probably should just get moving.
Well, I can't grab another one of those storm spheres, if that's what you're implying.
Yeah, no, we can't. Probably. That's why we should.
Oh,
go.
It's not still up? I assumed you were still casting it while he was casting Detect Magic.
Sorry.
Dude, it's everywhere.
Victoria, look at all this! Where did we get the tromping coming from?
Lightning bolt
behind us?
As a matter of fact, there appears to be some coming from that way.
Yes.
And from that way.
This way?
Yeah.
Coming from ahead of us, we should probably back out. However, we can leave the bag.
Yes.
The room. I will mage hand one more time, position it conspicuously on top of books and stuff so that it's not like buried or something.
Sure, just, sure.
And then we will back hide over here, I guess, since no one's coming from there.
Okay.
Yeah, there we go.
Marcus will, set up for like an ambush right here.
Okay.
I'll stand so right
as
in the hallway.
As they turn a corner.
Big ear to hair, bristling my fur and everything.
Yep. There we go. Alright.
Give them space so they can move. Be like,
role playing a bear.
Whenever he shows up as Bear, everyone's confused. Like, who is this guy?
Yeah, when I get this guy, I was like, who is that?
Yeah, what?
You like the idea.
Oh my god, he turned into a spider.
And then you're like, alright, yeah, I get it. You're a bear. No more bear. Yeah, in the spider form, too. But
I've got the real forms. I got the Goro ape. I've got the siege engine turtle.
I think I can do this. Screwed, Barrett.
I might swap mine out. And I'm thinking about
it. Yeah, siege engine sounds like pretty good.
Because then I would have 3 ships in a day.
It's like a 15 by 15. Jesus.
Does that do a lot of damage, or just really...
It does look ridiculous damage. I think the siege engine...
But it's a concentration check, so whenever it gets hit...
It does 4d10 plus 7, and if it hits with that, it can knock you prone and do an automatic 4d10 plus 7 to fall off.
It's basically a siege engine.
Yeah, it's a siege engine turtle. I mean,
for perspective, it's like, what is it, challenge rating 7?
Yeah, I think that's the 7.
Oh, my bear is challenge rating
6. Yeah.
So
polymorph is a little different.
And then how many of the? Because that's level 4, right?
Yeah. I can't do it right now.
Can you only do one or two? Or
I get one 4th level spell slot, and I can use an hour rest to get one back, and then I'm out until long rest.
Sure. The difference is that I get to keep like all my stats and stuff.
Right. Yeah, you become very dumb when you turn into a siege engine.
So he's easy to like. Yeah. But I'm assuming you can distinguish friend from foe.
Yeah, you keep your personality. That's about it. Anyway, so we are waiting in
the... So a siege engine that slits people, prisoners' throats.
Yeah. Fireball. It just stops on them and turns them into paste, really, at that point. It's not really interesting.
For the greater good!
I'd like to see the siege engine doing the dagger dance.
Oh, yeah.
I want to see the siege engine turtle do with a dodge.
So dodgy.
Yeah.
Okay, so you guys are huddled up in this hallway.
Waiting to see what happens when they find the bag of death.
Or are you actually looking, or are you just listening?
I am. I'm actually in the... I am literally positioned facing the hallway.
Facing the hallway, but there's
but
this
the
whole
bag.
Other...
Oh,
right.
The, bag,
the
yeah.
bag is in the entire other room.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Everyone give me a perception check.
You're screaming.
13.
17.
5.
10!
You hear screaming coming from the other room. It sounds like perhaps your trap has worked.
Uh-huh.
There's a bunch of startled grunts.
Should we ambush him?
Yes, let's go.
Right. Turn into a siege turtle.
You're collapsed by the surrounding earth.
Oh, no. I charge forth as a bear.
Oh boy.
Yeah, we're following. Alright. Yep. We're all following back in.
Okay. Great.
Terran's rushing with a bag of devouring.
Oh, where did it go? There's that. Oh, I pulled that. That's weird.
I don't suppose I get killing blow credit on the bag eating someone.
Sure. Absolutely.
Were you keeping track of that?
No.
Not only for describing it when we get around the corner. If it actually is killing someone.
Sure. There's a Taric half engorged.
We come around the corner and see what looks like a pair of legs sticking out of the bag of holding. But the legs are slowly shrinking down as the bag just wrestles around chomping the poor guy. And I assume some of them are trying to help him get it off.
No. They're standing as far back as they possibly can.
Just the geyser of blood.
You're already dead. Bag of the North Star.
Yes.
How much was that gold piece worth, by the way?
A gold. Yeah,
gold.
Just one gold.
Just one gold?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So that's basically like the... There's that thing in the...
No, that's not true. Excuse me. An actual gold piece would be like... 4 or 5
yeah,
gold
it's
bits.
Not
worth
it.
So that's not like the thing, like Yojimbo from Final Fantasy. You just throw away money to kill people.
Hey, we still might have the coin.
Use Gil.
Just loading it out.
Okay, roll it up.
That's a lot of guys.
You're a lot of guys.
I'm in the front.
Oh,
and
I did.
13. Someone bumps. You're disappointing me.
Is that in your way? I'm going to put it over here. I like that the only thing they have at 7-Eleven to bring your groceries back is a brown bag. Like, this is meant for 40s, not for a can of NOS.
Do you want some non-disposable shopping bags?
I wouldn't want anyone to know it either.
Yeah.
NOS disposable.
Not NOS disposable.
I wouldn't want me to know it.
Yeah.
That.
No.
What?
Should have seen the time they got pizza
okay.
from 7-Eleven. There. Everyone else actually
oh, we did. We all died.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, you weren't here when I was trying. So I wanted to bring cake from 7-Eleven to eat here, but I didn't have any, like, cake or pie or anything. I wanted 7-Eleven to get, like,
little baby.
Antoria.
No, like a birthday cake.
How are you still alive?
I was remarking earlier, he's actually in much better shape than I am.
It's the novelty of eating
Marcus?
Cake from 7-Eleven.
13.
I guess it does build your immune system up.
Yeah.
You can eat that and eat it with any regularity and not die.
I gotta say, I'm gonna eat it with regularity.
Marvin.
5.
Jeez.
I had to look again.
No,
way to represent, guys.
Yeah, somewhere with us.
Okay, well, the big guys are gonna go first. They charge. Who is that in the doorway?
That is Barrett.
Great.
Sure is.
Both of them close in.
They both fit. I guess it's big enough, right?
Absolutely. I mean, there's no shelves anymore.
I'm at the actual doorway.
There's always room for punching, Herbie.
Yeah.
That one fucking misses. This one hits and then critically misses.
My God, that's weird.
You take 11 points of punch damage, and then the big guy hits his friend for more than he hit you for.
Sweet.
This is the worst birthday ever.
Is it really your birthday?
It's not. I'm sorry.
Lies about everything.
It's not true. It's Herbie's birthday.
You know, it's my birthday on Thursday.
I did know that.
Did you?
Yeah, I got you something.
How did you know it's my birthday?
Facebook.
I looked it up.
Probably.
I did.
It's not on my Facebook.
I know.
He knows.
I don't
things.
Believe that's scary, and I don't believe.
Well, I'm sorry. I can withhold your present if you don't want it.
I'll take it.
Guys, 7-Eleven cake.
It's not. It's
yeah,
way better than that.
Not interested.
It's not interested. It's
a Marcus, it's your turn.
A lifetime supply of NOS.
That's a lot of NOS.
Or
two.
Yeah, that's really not that many.
So I can share. I just can't end my space, right?
Right.
And that's
Difficult terrain.
You can attack and move.
Actually,
back.
You could safely move there, and neither of them would get opportunity attacks. They've got reach, so you wouldn't be leaving even this guy's range.
Oh my!
So that'd give you an easy space you can get to and land in.
Yeah,
it also fine. Would open up a door for me to back out.
Yes, that's that. Yeah, I didn't realize that that would be not leaving in his reach. So
yeah, well,
then, absolutely.
Got 10 foot.
Who's the one that got
hit by his buddy?
By his buddy.
The one on the left.
This guy.
He can have a
yes.
bad day.
Yes.
Perfect. I'm attacking him.
Marcus
is here. I attack the guy with the lowest hit points.
Does a 15 hit?
No.
Okay. I'll swing.
Wait. Away. Yes. I got my monsters confused. 15 does hit him. I'm sorry.
That's okay. I will swing. Oh, okay. I'll do damage.
Do that.
Do they have whirlwind attack in this game? In this edition?
I think it exists.
There's a,
but it's a thing you have to take.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's a different...
Are you planning on getting that?
I think it's Barbarian, not Fighter.
Oh.
I think it's
it might be.
Oh, look, I'm not doing anything to my
I thought it was a Battle Master technique.
11 damage there. And then attack number 2. That's a hit.
Victoria, you're next.
15 damage there.
Okay. All done?
All done.
Victoria.
Alright. Let's see. I will. Alright. I will. Antoria gestures briefly and. Ball of fire appears behind the two big goos.
Oh, good.
And rams into the left one.
You actually hit a guy. The guy there.
Oh, there is a guy here? Oh, give me my fireball back and place him slightly differently.
Take that!
The bookshelves are gone. So, fine.
Stop touching me!
My fireball.
Poke, poke, poke.
What
do right.
you want?
Alright,
work done.
It's a DC 15 dex save.
Great. These guys are dexterous as shit. No, they're not.
Well, shit isn't very dexterous.
10 or 5.
But actually, all of them are great. All of them are adept at dodging sudden flaming spheres dropped into their midst.
Just 5.
As those they've practiced those routines regularly in their private gym that they have memberships to.
Yeah, there's a Gold's Gym right on the 4th floor.
Yes. Don't try to get in. Barrett.
Now it's my turn.
No, excuse me. Emboldened, your lizard friend actually jabs his little makeshift spear at one of the big guys.
I guess he had to move up then.
Yeah.
Oh my god, he's gonna get eaten.
But it misses.
Well. Now
it's Barrett's turn.
Alright, Tori looks really alarmed for his lizard friend, but nothing can do it now.
I will claw and bite the guy that is... can't even see where I'm reaching. They're so big! They're so tall!
Thank you.
You're welcome.
I worked hard.
I guess I'll go for the one that he was attacking.
Okay.
Focus tactics.
Yeah.
Oh, dark was claws, but I think they're both going to miss anyway.
Your new dice are great.
Yeah, they're doing great. Does a 12 hit?
12 does not hit.
Yeah, I'm done.
Goodbye.
He's gonna go home.
Marvin, it's your
yeah,
turn.
Yeah, I'm done for the night. See you guys.
The rest of the Tyrics are going next.
I'm here to soak damage. That's my job.
Okay. I'm gonna cast Cloud Daggers on... This is the guy that didn't take any damage, right?
Yeah, he's the...
Precious. Can I see that?
You can...
You're in the doorway.
Through the doorway. I mean, they're big.
No.
I have to be able to see that square there.
He's large, and he's not forward into the hallway.
Okay. You probably can't see that square.
What if I was
there?
Like to push this dude out of the way?
You could do that.
Can I?
Yeah, you can do
like,
that.
Like be on his square. What I don't know.
You can literally shove him out of the way. Give me a strength check.
Strength check.
It won't take that much. He's a little guy.
13.
Yeah, look at that.
Okay.
All right.
See?
So I'll use Cloud of Daggers.
Tori actually looks a little relieved.
And we don't have a mini for that anymore.
What?
Like, we keep losing that.
We keep making them and then losing them because they're so small.
Yeah.
They're just a square.
What we need is an actual dagger.
A cloud of them.
Shove it into the table.
Just stab whatever you want.
Yeah.
Wait.
We should just make one of these standees.
Yeah!
There's the old one.
Buddy.
Sorry, I'm trying to read the... Because this thing confuses
the Washington Post.
No, I'm trying to read
does
what
that entertain
the internet
you?
Says about when this should actually damage. So, right now we'll just do what we've been doing.
Right.
What? On him?
On him.
Okay.
Basically on that sword right there.
Fit on the...
Put it next to
on
him.
On the man's.
Yeah. And do you want me to roll for...
they can't be in both.
Right?
But they can't occupy the same square.
That's amazing.
Square.
Technically, they should be on, like, the center of four
yeah.
squares.
Yeah,
right.
That's what I tried to do, but anyway.
What's up?
I didn't do the wild magic anyway.
Okay.
That's all I've got.
Well, that was an astounding turn. Thank you very much. These guys are... I guess two of them are going to move, like, to this side of the wall, and then the others are going to move...
These ones?
Yeah, but they're going to, like, take a wide berth around the bag, because they just saw their friend got eaten.
All right, so where do you want... You want these guys to go here?
That makes sense. And then those...
Here?
That one's good. And then take those others and push them towards Lobos.
Like here?
Yeah. Yeah! Oh, wait.
There's
but still in the room.
There's a ball of fire in the way. They could
get them away from the ball of fire.
Okay.
But still on that side of the room, and that's all they're going to do.
He would be at a wall then.
Well, then, being at the wall is fine. They're not going to try and engage.
Okay.
Their
yeah.
big
so
friends are in
the
way.
Like, okay.
Yeah.
You
thank you.
Okay.
Okay. Big guys are going to continue to wail on the bear.
So, at the beginning of the left guy's turn.
Oh my god.
Jeez. Excuse me. He's going to be taking. 14 damage of slashing damage.
14 on 44, wow.
Yeah, I know, I rolled 3 fours.
Okay.
Jeez.
Anything else?
No, that's it.
Okay. Like their compatriots before, you guys see their wounds sort of stitch themselves back together. And they heave their claws in a bearward direction. That's one hit.
That's all I'm good for anymore.
That's both misses.
Wow,
so you're gonna take. There's a lot of misses
well,
right
got
there.
13 now.
I rolled a lot of single digits.
I know, it's still bad, but.
You take 10 points of claw damage, and then they both try and sink their teeth into you as well. And both of those will hit.
Okay.
You take 16 points of bite damage.
So, 26 altogether?
Yes.
So it looks like we were doing it right. Because it says when you enter the square, and this is a case of the spell entering the guy's square.
Yeah.
So that.
Well, the thing is, it'd be two automatic hits if it worked that way, too.
Right, but there's a lot of possibilities for them to be removed from that square before they can even get hit.
Yeah.
But there's also possibilities for me to cast it behind and then
Marcus
like punch a dude.
Enter your next.
Enter the square that way.
I'm gonna keep attacking this left guy.
Oh wait, they both take flaming spear damage.
Oh.
Sorry.
DC 15 dex saves. Will be 7 or 3.
Nothing. It's 7.
Alright.
Is the amount that they take.
Q. We're having ourselves a barbecue.
Something we're not immune to.
We're not immune, but never mind.
Resistant.
Yeah, attack on the left dude.
Okay.
24. Oh, shit.
Reroll. I got it.
It wasn't very good.
First hit 16 damage.
Great!
Still
excuse
up.
You.
Oh.
Sharky.
He's still alive.
Tell her to get her shit together.
Wait, it's on Tumblr. I have to look at it. She's got really good Tumblr pics. Sorry, everyone.
Well, stream over.
Yeah.
Tumblr.
Thanks for coming over to my house.
Is Pig still up?
Which one? Yeah, these guys are fine.
Okay, good.
16 to the one on the left.
Good. And then a 19?
That hit.
19 will hit.
Excellent. Okay, 7, 12, 13 damage to the left one again.
Okay.
And I'm gonna brain punch.
No.
Brain punch.
The left one as well. DC 12 wisdom save.
You guys seem pretty.
Fail.
Bad.
Fail. Well, takes 4 damage.
Anything else?
They fail disadvantage on tech rolls until end of next turn.
Nice. Antoria!
Alright.
Barret, you're next.
Rams the flaming sphere.
This is a terrible combat track.
Antoria waits for the combat music to be updated. Okay. Well, 5 or 2 on a DC 15 dex save.
5 or 2?
Yeah. I know, it's exciting.
Yeah.
Stoked. Stoked, I tell you.
For lefty.
Success.
Edge of 2. And then Antoria will gesture briefly and send a firebolt at the left one. Does a 14 hit?
Mm-mm.
Alright. I'm done.
Barret.
Alright. Let's do it again. The one that everyone's been beaten on. Dark is a claw.
Marcus.
Ooh. Well, hey, you got a 20 on something finally.
I got a 20 and a 19, so both are gonna hit.
What?
The bite is a crit, though.
Hey, bears can do damage.
Yeah, what do you know?
You think all that propaganda about them being fearsome creatures
eight,
is such a crap.
An 8? Wow, I rolled 2 8s. 16, 21,
8, 13, 20,
34 damage. Wow.
Wow! Describe for us your killing blow.
Alright.
Damn!
Since it was the bite that did the killing blow, the crit, then I will rip out his jugular.
Okay.
Yep.
It's yours now.
It is now my jugular.
Ah, God, it's my blood.
Nice job. Is it?
Great.
Done.
Marvin, your turn.
Yeah, it was not him, but yeah.
So, I want to use Acid Splash, and it says that I can hit.
You can do whatever you want.
Within 5 feet of each other. Is it plausible that I could hit this guy without seeing him? Because, like, if I was hitting this guy and acid was splashing
splatter
out,
yeah.
Would you feel like that makes sense, or...?
I'm all about it.
Okay, so I'm going to use Acid Splash. Both of these guys have to do dex 16 saves.
Oh my god.
Does
I regret my choices.
No, it's just two creatures.
Okay.
Ugh.
That's a shame.
So
don't worry, you'll be fine.
it's friendly.
It's friendly. It's just rub it on your face.
Big guy takes 5 points acid damage.
Great.
Small guy takes 4 points of acid damage.
It's just a damage.
That's all I got. I'll say.
I'll say.
Hold the position. Let them come through the swarm of daggers.
It's benign to friendlies.
All right, the Terrics are going next.
Is that the big ones?
No, that's the small ones.
Little ones.
Fireball's kind of in an interesting position for them. Yeah, go ahead, take up the front.
They're actually going to, like, retreat, like, in a away kind of direction. and the big guy, he'll center up in the doorway.
Is it his turn?
It is.
Okay, so he's going to take some slashing damage. Four, five,
yeah.
Eight.
Slashing. Can't wait till we get the real version of that spell.
That's the real version.
He seems to mend up pretty quickly.
Acid leaks into his wound.
Oh no!
Well, no, that's lore.
Well, some stuff does.
You have to roll the attack.
No, I mean, like, there's actual acid attacks that do acid damage after. Yeah, a little tedious, but
20.
Right, but I'm saying mine doesn't.
For 8 times,
that's too bad.
1d8 plus 6.
You should get one of the other ones.
I'm living rolling up your die. No worse than scorching.
Does
ray.
It look like it's stitching it all up, or just like...
Not all of it, no.
Yeah,
actually, the scorch wounds seem to not be sealing up.
Now, when he ended his turn, he's got some scorchy damage to do, or the attack.
He hasn't ended, he's still attacking.
Sorry.
He's just started.
Yeah, sorry.
What's your AC, Barret?
My AC is 13.
Okay. Then I'll hit with both claws.
Not that high. Just bear fur.
That's... You're going to take 25 total claw damage? Great. Then it's time to get bitten in the face.
No. Oh, no. Real face.
That will also hit.
Alright.
You take 7 points of bite damage.
So how much was that total?
Sorry, 25 and then 7.
Yeah.
Okay. So 32.
32 total. And then it's Marcus's turn. But then...
It's fireball smacked.
Great.
For 6 or 3.
Who turns into a human when he's wounded.
Exactly.
He's a...
Deep down.
Bearware.
Bearware.
He saves.
Okay, and just 3.
But still, ouch.
Marcus!
Alright. More great sword swipes from... in his front corner. 24
hits.
12 damage.
Yes.
And 13.
13 to hit?
Yeah.
No, sorry.
Alright.
Whish! Great sword slices through the air.
That's
it for me.
Alright. I will ram the spear into our friend again.
Ah, Marvin.
Yeah. DC 15 dex as usual for 2 or 1. Jesus Christ.
Oh, I take a measly 1.
Right. And explode.
I just imagine one day saying, describe your reluctant killing blow.
It's like the fireball rip, you know, lazily strolls over to the end here.
Alright, and then Toria will gesture and send a fireball at him. Firebolt probably hits with a 25.
Yes.
Yeah, I would have been a big surprise if that didn't hit. And deals 18 fire damage.
Yeah!
That's pretty huge.
Fine. Anything else?
Nope, that's it.
Okay. Lizardman tries to... Not very hard to make his way up to the front. Barret!
Alright. Yeah, I'm just going to leave the bear there because I'm going to shift again. So. And that's it for my shifts for the day. And then I'm going to go ahead and bite the bomb again. Because that's what I do. We'll reflect his claw again. Good chances. Does a 20 hit. No, roll 13. 20 hit.
What?
There's a 20 hit.
20 hits.
Yeah, okay.
Stop saying numbers on dice. They don't matter.
Sorry.
Unless they're 20 or 1.
It's true. Or a 19 if you're marking.
Yeah. Don't confuse Bill. It's already...
What's going on? Are we playing D&D?
Not 15 anymore.
15 and 6, 21 damage.
Describe for us.
Ooh, I got both.
Your killing blow.
All right, this one's just getting clawed in half.
Half.
Artistic.
Yep.
Beautiful, really.
Yep.
Oh, at least you didn't get my circular.
And that's it for me. I'm not gonna move you.
Yeah.
Sorry.
That's fine. Marvin.
I'll step in here into the room and fireball this one. With Tides of Chaos for advantage.
Of course.
That was 19. That's cocked.
19 hits.
For 17 points of fire damage.
Alright, you describe for us your killing blow.
Nice.
Or was that 11? I don't know.
Just kill him.
It doesn't matter. He's like, I think I killed him. Wait, no, maybe I didn't. And then he gets set on fire. And then he briefly fades out of fire, but then he gets caught on fire. There you go. Now he's dead.
His fellows turn and flee out of the room.
I have some bad news.
Yes?
Storm Spear is not the only spell that hits friendlies.
Oh, really?
Yeah. DC 15 dex save.
Oh, no!
Too close.
Well, that's fine.
I failed.
Play the fire. You get
10 damage then. Oh. Sorry.
I'll turn
Wait, no, can't you stop concentrating?
Why would he do
no,
that?
No, it has to be his turn.
Oh.
No, I didn't have to, I don't know if I can do it as a reaction. That is true. I've never looked it up before.
I would assume at any point, because like if someone were to hit you, you'd break concentration.
Yeah,
so
right.
I don't know. Your call.
Yeah.
I mean, I think it's better.
Yeah.
Frank gets hurt.
Yeah, yeah, I think that's way better.
And Toria is always very much like, oh god, please don't hurt you.
He usually is. He's leaving
that's
it up because you'd have to recast it.
And Toria still has targets
yeah.
there.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
I'll snap my glaze over there and say, what the shit was that?
You stood next to a fire.
No, you have to wait for your turn.
Shut up, it's not your turn to speak.
You could ask nicely, I might have set my shield.
I'm holding the stick of truth.
What are the little guys doing?
They turn and flee the room.
Okay.
They've had enough.
Yeah, I think they've. Yeah.
They left the combat scene?
Actually, they're gonna run through that door to the south. No, there's a door in that room.
Like here?
Isn't there one?
Yeah,
no, there's not.
Right here.
No, that's north. I thought there was one across
the
room.
The south.
Never mind. Door. They run out the way that they came originally.
Okay.
Screaming in terror.
Mm. Assuming they're gone.
And we're going to drop out of initiative order.
Okay, I will end the fireball.
Terrific.
Well, Herbie, I hope you've got a healing potion for me.
This is
I mean, Antoria. I stopped my concentration.
Okay.
Because I'm a responsible spellcaster.
Right, yeah, I remember eating some fireballs before, but yeah, you're responsible. Oh, wait, I'm sorry.
Toria frowns a little bit. Sorry, I thought everyone knew by now not to stand next to those.
Why would I?
Well, you've been burned by it before, I
think. I haven't. No, I haven't.
Maybe that was someone else. I'm sorry.
Yes.
You know what they say. If you can't stand the heat,
yell
at Antoria.
Well, we can either try resuming our search or we can rest. I mean, they got away. They might come back with even more help at some point. What do you want to do? There could be valuable things here. I can find them if we can hold out for 10 minutes.
Or an hour.
I'll get started. Make up your minds while I'm busy.
Everyone give me a perception check.
Okay.
20.
7.
With smell?
15.
Not with smell. Actually, with hearing.
With hearing. Alright.
9. Do ears have bears?
Bears?
That's what I thought.
Barriers.
You guys hear a rhythmic pounding to the south.
You just gave me a really good idea for a pun.
And it's coming closer?
We haven't heard this
one yet. It's
not,
no.
Oh man.
A barrier.
Sounds...
What does it sound like?
Oh, not bad. Like someone banging on a door.
Mm.
And we'll investigate what exactly that is, I think, next week.
Good enough.
Sound good?
Bury your head in sand.
I'm not going to do that, Ryan.
Happy Surround birthday. Yourself with a barrier.
Happy birthday.
Hopefully not.
Do you
want to
see what I got you for your birthday?
Not looking so good.
Sure.
Is it a
Green Lantern card? I swear to God.
It's a tiny Tabasco sauce.
What? This is awesome. I could put this
he
on a
Christmas tree. He sounded so touched.
I could put this on a Christmas tree.
You could. Or eggs.
Wow.
Well, thank you.
You're welcome.
I can also drink this.
You could.
I'm not going to, though.
Hey, 7-Eleven food might actually taste like something.
Yes, that's a good idea.
And will taste like Tabasco, which is what everything
is
that you put Tabasco in. It is.
Yeah, that's an improvement.
It is. I admit.
You know, 7-Eleven has its own brand of chips.
That doesn't
sound good.
No, I mean, I looked
what,
at it.
You said
like,
that like that was a defense. Like, I'll have you know.
They have their own chips, damn it.
And
they
had this thing, I almost got it and brought it for Lobos, was a bacon wrapped 7-Eleven dog.
That's disgusting.
Oh, that sounds good.
Yeah. Is it really just like...
No, it was a whole sausage.
I love
the letters 7-Eleven made of styrofoam wrapped
not,
in bacon.
As long as they haven't been sitting there an entire day.
Well, that's the thing. It probably has been. It's on the little roller.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So story time about Lobos. Do you remember when you got that
you just go
hot dog at Willie's?
They restock them.
You got a hot dog at Willie's?
So we were on the road trip with the band, and we stopped.
Was this to Arkansas?
It was away from.
I don't remember. I think we're going to Dallas.
Or something.
Oh
way,
man!
We stopped at this big
was DeSonicon?
Trucker stop between the cities, and everyone's getting back in the car, and of course, fucking Lobos comes in with his like, you know, like those little like convenient or those
yeah.
concession stand
paper things with its hot dog across it.
Yes.
And, like, we're starting the car, and someone is like, okay, who stepped in dog shit? Somebody stepped in dog shit out there. And Mom was like, no, it's my hot dog.
Was it good, though?
I almost want to...
It was amazing.
It literally smelled like shit.
No,
I almost want to say that that might have been the trip to Fayetteville, because I want to say that I've heard that story. But the only time that I can think of you going on a trip to the north that I would have heard it would have been Fayetteville.
I thought it was Sonic.
I don't know.
I did. I think it may have been a thing that I told you.
It might just be a Lobos Legends that has been communicated to me.
Lobos eating the shit hot dogs.
Poop hot dogs.
Alright.
Poop dogs.
Well, for more Dungeon Crawling and Lobos Legends, we'll see you next week. Thank you, everyone, for tuning in.
Bye, Stray.
We'll see you next time.
Bye, Stray. Also, if you know Shaquille O'Neal's contact.
Also, if you know Shaquille O'Neal.
Or Jonathan Blows.
Yeah.